Halloween is characterized around the idea of legends, stories told about the past. College football is full of legends, and none are more synonymous with a university like the number 44 is at Syracuse. A legacy unlike any other. Today, the Orange hope to build upon their storied past as they clash with the Wolfpack of NC State on this Halloween weekend in Syracuse. This first Saturday in November, we welcome you to Central New York. And after two road games, Halloween weekend, the Orange of Syracuse have returned home to the Carrier Dome. After a win at Wake Forest and a 10-point loss at Clemson last Saturday, Scott Schaefer's team is back. And to meet them, Dave Doran and the Wolfpack of North Carolina State, who started 4-0 but have lost four straight and come to Central New York off a bye. Eighth meeting all time and the fourth time in Syracuse for the Wolfpack of NC State and the host Orange. And we welcome you to our ACC College Football Saturday booth with James Bates, Wes Durham. Jen Hildreth will join us in just a moment from the sideline. 5 weeks to go in the regular season. One look at either side of the ACC standings, you see how tight it is, particularly in the Coastal. But the Atlantic, after Florida State's win the other night against Louisville, while the Seminoles may be the favorite on that side, both these teams could certainly use a win.
Oh, both these teams used to going to bowl games. They need some wins, though. Like you said, for Syracuse, they need three more. Just three wins on the year. You mentioned the 4-0 start for NC State. They need two more, but it's going to be a blood fight today to try to get that next one and get some extra bowl practices in. These are some young teams, and these coaches know how important it is.
Well, the Wolfpacks lost four straight in ACC play. They played well. Offensively, they're starting to find a groove, and what a weapon for Jacoby Brissett.
Yeah, they run it a little bit, can throw it a little bit, and especially the last few games, the big sophomore tight end. They talk about a security blanket being those tight ends. How's this for a nice, cuddly blanket? 6'5", 270-pounder, 17 catches. The last two games, that went for 243 yards and three touchdowns. And even better, Wes, he can come in and block for you, too, in the run game. So as a defensive coordinator, Chuck Bulla and company, you're playing that chess game and trying to match up. Fortunately for the guys in orange, well, they've got some pretty good chess pieces, and I think the best pieces on this attacking defense are two senior linebackers. Guys like Dyshawn Davis making his 44th start today for the Orange. That's more starts than anybody on the team. And this guy right here, boy, is he fun to watch, ladies and gentlemen. A senior linebacker from Georgia, Cameron Lynch. 5.5 sacks on the year. That's fourth in the ACC. And he just loves the game of football. You turn on the tape and you watch him play, you know that these guys are having some fun no matter what they're doing.
Well, while the teams try and shake it, so do these head coaches, Jen. Both Dave Doran and Scott Schaefer know they can shake out of this pretty quick with a victory here today.
Yeah, Wes, you know, I had a chance to talk to both head coaches, and I think you could say their coaching skills certainly being put to the test right now, but I did ask them about their approach for these final four games. For Scott Schaefer at Syracuse, this is a guy, as many of you know, who wears his emotions on his sleeve, but it's about working through that stress. We saw a little bit of in our meetings yesterday and making sure his team doesn't see any of that. All they see is strength and a belief this team can do what it did last year. Mega late push, get to a ball. Dave Doran's team had an off week to get in a little extra work. They made cut-ups of every guy, asked him one thing they could do to make the team better, and he reminded them, guys, it's okay to go out there and have fun. They put on a talent show, and he feels like his team comes in here with some good energy. Wes, that could be a real advantage going against a Syracuse team playing its eighth game in 9 weeks without a break.
No question. And both these teams, State coming off of eight straight games. Syracuse has played eight in the last 9 weeks. We get to our four keys, Batesy.
Well, the third is the word. Third down, I mean, offensively for NC State, 46.2% of the time they convert. 52, though, others on the defense. So defensively, they have got to get better at getting off of the field. Home cooking, whatever that is around here. I've asked a couple of people. I think it's dinosaur barbecue, the more I ask. But I'm not talking about the food. I'm talking about being back home where they belong, right here in the Carrier Dome. Such a special venue. One of the greatest in college football. Whether the Orange are winning or losing, these two teams, their hometown fans really support them, and they want to get some momentum going after a couple games on the road.
Cole Murphy gets us started. Matt Days will play from the near side at the goal line. And Days, who had a 50-yard return against Boston College, out across the 20. And the Wolfpack will take the field first. And, of course, NC State, 10th in total offense in the ACC at 406 yards a game. And there is the rifleman, so to speak, Jacoby Brissett.
Well, Jacoby Brissett, he's not really your two-way guy that you hear so much about at that quarterback spot. But he does do a lot of work and a lot of damage with his feet. But it's more in a shiftiness and a buying time type of situation. But he's got to get back on track like he was his first four.
Far side, this is Bo Hines working up the far side. Got a nice block out in space by Braylon Cherry. And so NC State about half the distance. Here's the Toyota Impact players for the Wolfpack.
Well, and that freshman, Bo Hines, is one of them. He's got to have a big day. Great possession receiver, great route runner. And whether it's Thornton, whether it's Days or Creasy, the three-man show in the backfield has to be successful.
Here is Greenidge on cue. And David Greenidge, a first down for the Wolfpack, out to the 45-yard line. The safety, Darius Kelly, makes the stop. And NC State's in a hurry-up mode. And Brissett's hit his first two passes.
Why not? Plenty of rest. Time to get healthy and get fresh, and they look good to start.
And this is Jonathan Austin, sophomore, making the catch. He was one of a handful of NC State players that were suspended for the Louisville ball game. Back in the lineup today is Austin, his 15th catch of the year. Brissett hits Hines, four straight for Jacoby Brissett. And Dyshawn Davis, the linebacker, over to make the stop. We look at the orange impact players brought to you by Toyota on defense.
Senior defensive end Robert Welch has forced a turnover in three straight games, including that interception return for a touchdown against Wake. And Darrell Eskridge, the junior safety. Tall, long, rangy, great football player.
There is Thornton out of the backfield. Another Wolfpack first down. State well into Syracuse territory, knocked out at about the 31 by Hodge. The third of those three dynamic linebackers for Syracuse.
It's a little bit more like it. And it's a run game that they'll get with their wide receiver, their little now routes, their quick screens. They'll sweep it out there. That's technically just a sweep to a running back. And here they go back to the ground, and it's stuffed in the first play that hasn't done all kinds of damage. And the Syracuse defense finally able to come up and get some air, catch their breaths.
State's got no intention of huddling here, though, James. Brissett, five of his first five for 47 yards.
Looking like a team that started the season 4-0 and the way they started the FSU game.
Brissett up in the pocket and going to spin to pick up 2 or 3 yards. So it'll be third down for the Wolfpack. Cameron Lynch, Micah Robinson sandwich Jacoby Brissett here.
You see what I mean, Wes, about these feet? They've got them. One, two. Two guys missed, now three. And what looked to be a loss turns into a 3-4 yard gain to bring up a third down and 5 as opposed to a third down and 10 or 11. That's Jacoby Brissett for you. Now can they convert and cap off what has been a great start here offensively out after the bye week?
Creasy's coming to ball game. He's to the right of Brissett. Syracuse draws those corners in tight. Pressure coming to his left. Throwing is Brissett and dropped. Intended for Hines. Lynch and Hodge were pressuring Brissett. And on the back end, Darius Kelly almost comes up with the interception.
Look at Lynch jump over the top of Creasy. The back went down low. He didn't touch him, but again, he didn't touch Brissett, so it should have been even worse field goal range. Bad position, but an incomplete pass, so you live to try to get three out of this one from Sadie.
Sadie's long field goal try is good. Nicholas Sadie hammers a 43-yard field goal. State draws first blood at the Carrier Dome. Well, Dave Dorn and the Wolfpack get a field goal out of the up-tempo possession to start this ball game. James Sadie, a 43-yard field goal, and it's his seventh of the year. So a 3-0 lead for the Wolfpack. And now the Orange will get the ball, and there's a look at the freshman from West Haven, Connecticut, Urban Phillips, who is averaging 19 yards a return, 10th best in the ACC. Prince Tyson Gully's also back there with him. And Phillips will watch the kick of Sadie go all the way through the end zone. And the Orange will will play from their 25-yard line. And we get a look here at the young freshman, just the third career start for A.J. Long. Asar Jr., by the way, enrolled in January, Division II Mr. Football at Friendship Christian Academy in suburban Nashville, Tennessee, originally from Bangor, Pennsylvania, where he also was a very decorated quarterback.
Well, and just over a month ago, he was the third-string quarterback.
Yep.
And thrown into the fire, and with the exception of that Clemson game, has really looked good. It's important to get his feet back underneath him here in this game early today.
Little counter out of the gun, and Gully cuts back, and he'll have a first down and ruled down at the 37 before the ball popped loose under the tackle of Jones. And Big Thomas Teal back there as well for NC State.
Once you hit November, once you hit this home stretch, whether you're fighting for a bowl game or not, who loves football? It shows. Prince Tyson Gully has been waiting all week to get his hands on the football and run this first play. And you're going to get the best you've got out of number 23 all day long today. His plays here at Syracuse are numbered. Just a few more left for the senior.
The 12-yard run carried him over 500 yards rushing on the season. He gets it right there after the 12-yard pickup and got hammered straight out by Dravius Wright. And here are the impact players for the Orange on offense, brought to you by Toyota.
Well, and Prince Tyson Gully becomes more important than ever when you've got A.J. Long there taking the snaps at quarterback. Ishmael, of course, another young guy for the Orange, a big-time playmaker outside.
Third straight carry for Prince Tyson Gully. Thomas Teal makes the play out of that front for NC State.
Wes, last time we had this Wolfpack team, remember, it was a nice fight that they gave in Louisville against a very tough team that we saw lose a close one on Thursday night to FSU, one of the better teams in the ACC, and that was without eight or nine guys that were suspended. T.Y. McGill up front, the only one still suspended.
Here's Long's first pass, and it's caught. Middle of the field. And his cousin, Jared West, holds it in. And a first down for the Orange at the NC State 46.
And for an offensive line, watch him up front, protecting four guys come. Nice pocket for A.J. Long. It was an O-line that still in pregame, they weren't sure who was going to be able to go. So many injuries. Good job.
First down give. Gully trying to redirect. Long tried to help him, but Dravius Wright, sophomore nickel in the 4-2-5 for Dave Doran. And also Rodman Noel stood up Prince Tyson Gully.
Well, a sophomore, and look at all the white jerseys. And Dravius Wright, every time out here in 2014, has become a better football player. Coach Doran making sure he stays on the outside, though, because that could have been a big hitter for Gully.
Loss of nine, and referee Jeff Heaser.
First timeout, Syracuse.
So there you have it. When you have the true freshman making his third career start, sometimes you got to get the mechanics and the communication smoothed out. And the Orange will huddle up. NC State the early lead, though, at the Carrier Dome. ACC football is brought to you by Toyota. Well, right outside the Carrier Dome, statue of the 1961 Heisman Trophy winner, one we lost way too soon in life, Ernie Davis, one of the legends for the Orange. Out of a Syracuse timeout, Long's pass, and broken up on the way to Quinta Funderburk, the transfer from Arkansas.
Gotta hold on to that one. Yes, that is a punter, ladies and gentlemen, as an impact player, because he's the best in the ACC, Will Bowman. 46.9 on the average, and Rodman Noel defending those receivers on the perimeter, rushing the passer, and running down Gully today is big.
Long hit as he throws, and it is almost intercepted. Deflected by Josh Jones, and then Big Thomas Teal almost got the Christmas present the day after Halloween.
A.J. Long's going to take a pop. Watch this. Here comes the rush off the edge. Good hustle. They go up a little high. No flag, though. A little tap on the ear hole to boot. And remember, A.J. Long, for a guy thrown into the mix, not expecting it, has been pretty good until that Clemson game, and they got after him in Death Valley last weekend.
First punt of the day for Riley Dixon Hines. Coming to make the play. And picked it up, and then markers everywhere. And this might be kick catch interference on Corey Winfield, the redshirt freshman from St. Louis. And Jeff Heiser's group will huddle up here as assigned by the Atlantic Coast Conference. And here is referee Heiser.
There is no foul on the play. I was back into first down.
Wolfpack will take over, and Jen's got a very special guest.
I do, Wes. This is Sergeant First Class Jeff Hackett. Who, Jeff, you had a pretty good experience today, didn't you? Got to run out in front of the team.
It was awesome, I tell you. You know, it's been a while since I ran, but you know, that was probably the first I ran, and this is the first time on my running leg. I just got it from the VA, so. It was awesome. So.
You're out there for the coin toss, I know as well.
That I wasn't ready for that. I didn't know I was going to do that. But you know what? It was very exciting. You know, first time for that. And I wouldn't mind doing it again, you know? So.
Well, they should have you back. Now, you lost your leg on a tour of duty in Afghanistan, I understand. I love what you told one of the guys before you ran out when they said, watch out, you don't want to get run over by the team. What did you tell him?
Well, basically said, I've been blown up, so, you know, that'll be nothing, you know. Pick myself up and get up and go, you know.
But you were getting the crowd fired up, too, in your honor. Are you enjoying this whole moment?
I get like that, man. I tell you, it's, you know, you got to live the moments, you know. And to get people fired up like I did, you know, it's great, you know, real great. Yeah.
It's a pleasure to meet you and have you here. Thank you so much for your service.
Thank you very much.
Well, Wes, great story down here.
Boy, no kidding. And Jeff Hackett, from all of us up here and everybody on our crew and everybody in this country, thank you for what you've done. What a moment for him. Pretty good for us, too.
Amen. Thank you, Sergeant Hackett. That was those guys that walked out with him wearing those Syracuse orange uniforms.
Yeah.
You know, these coaches do such a good job. You don't always hear of making sure they're surrounded by veterans like that and understand how fortunate they are and how strong those men and women are that are protecting them. There's a nice pickup on second and short by Brissett.
Here he is on the boot, and that's Hines. Out to the NC State 39-yard line. James a little slower on the second possession for offensive coordinator Matt Canada, and the rookie Hines, another big catch.
Well, but same result. This time to Bo Hines, who got banged up a little bit earlier this year in the Boston College game. Good to have him back out there. In it, the success has come on first down. Look at this. Again, you find yourself in another second down and four. That's why they're one of the better teams in the ACC on third downs, because of what they do on first down. Empty set now.
Yep, Brissett checks everybody out of there. Pressure coming, and far side and incomplete, intended for Jonathan Alston.
And that's rolling the dice. You've got more than they can block. You bring the pressure. You trust your guys and man on the outside. And Brissett stands in there, just delivers it a little bit short, and would have been a first down, and there was plenty of cushion there on the receiver. But now you get a stop on second, trying to do it again. Orange defense on third down.
NC State brings Cole Cook in as a tight end, three receivers. And you see Creasy's also in the ball game to the right of Brissett. To his right, sets, pumps. Now got to break away, and the Orange rally to the football. Lynch and Hodge collapse in from linebacker to make the play on Jacoby.
Well, Marquise Hodge, the middle linebacker, 33. See him spying, trying to keep that outside shoulder free. Brissett almost slips through. But when you've got Cameron Lynch, it's going to come hunt down and clean up. Watch 38 come into this frame. Boom. You're not going to get out of the grasp of him very often. He is, like we said earlier, just a fun football player to watch. And he's such a tough guy. And when he gets his paws on you, it's done.
Richie DeSeer waits on the punt of Ballman. And it's a good one. DeSeer will run off. It'll check up. How about this stuff? Inside. Down by Jalen Samuels, the fullback. Man, that's why he's an impact player.
That is why you make that man an impact player. Like Nostradamus up here in the booth. Oh, they're cooking it up, Wes. We'll be right back. It's 3-0. NC State early in this one.
59-yard punt by Will Bauman has backed the Orange up. And Otto rallying Syracuse. Meanwhile, James Bates' impact player.
That's right.
Delivers.
Well, look at that mustache on the backup punter, William Stevenson. Man, he's lucky he beat him out just for the mustache alone. It is Movember. But that, how many times you see a guy that's worried about those numbers? He's leading the ACC and just punched it out of the back of the end zone trying to pat him. Beautiful punter.
Long hands to Gully on first down. We'll pick up about 4 to 6.
And that's why he's an impact player for the defense. Look at this position he puts his defense in. And you know what I'm talking about, right, Wes?
Yeah.
I mean, he's like, here's a guy, oh, gosh, I'm leading the ACC. Gosh, I got to get all this. I want to stay right there.
Well, he's and a finalist just, for the Ray Guy Award.
Right, right. He just punts it out of the back of the end zone. Big guy, too, 6'6", 190-pounder from Wilmington, North Carolina. So here's a second down and 7 now for the Orange offense.
Gully's 6th carry in 2 possessions, and NC State rallies. Rodman Noel has been in the mix here as one of the linebackers for NC State. Boy, we've seen linebackers on both squads make plays here early.
And Noel, what he does is he doesn't, it's not a blitz, he just reacts. And what, and Gully's trying to bend it back. And so many times you'll see a younger linebacker run himself out of there. Oh, Flo's going the other way. Let me get out of here, go make this play. Stays at home and gets a big drop for a loss.
So now, 3rd and a full 10, and Gully on the carry. No surprise, don't put it in the hands of the true freshman to throw from the end zone there, James. But Gully doesn't get very much, and Syracuse, after the great punt by Bauman, he did the heavy lifting, so to speak, and then teed up the defense for Dave Doran.
Well, it's been a couple stands for Syracuse, forcing a field goal on the first series. NC State was rolling, seemed to be rolling on the second, but that's not going to stay very long. They're not going to stay tough very long if they can't run the football offensively, and they forced the true freshman, A.J. Long, to win this football game. They have got to get that ground game going. Great job by the Wolfpack D.
Dixon from the back line of the end zone, and Hines plays at midfield. Bo Hines trying to find a seam, and will pick up about 12 yards on the return. So State will start in plus territory with a 3-0 lead after the 47-yard punt. How about our ACC stories? Well, coming into week 10 in the Atlantic Coast Conference, boy, Marquise Williams has been special last 2 weeks against Georgia Tech and Virginia last Saturday in Charlottesville. And here they go. Every time you think they're not what they are who they thought you were. They are who you thought they were, right?
Aren't they? What a game on Thursday night in Louisville, and what a tough one for Bobby Petrino's Cards. Boy, did they ever play some good football. Just got a little sloppy. Put the ball on the ground.
First down play, Shadrack Thornton picks up about 5 to the 34. So Shad Thornton before Hodge and Robinson out of that front 7 for Chuck Bulla and Syracuse. This is a fascinating matchup, James, simply because since Syracuse's offense is pretty much 20 personnel, 2 backs, no tight ends, NC State's got all the personnel groups. Well, both these defensive coordinators, Dave Huxtable, the Wolfpack, Chuck Bulla, the Orange, they've had to be on cue this week.
Here they'll go empty. Do it so many different ways. Strong throw, but a double catch, and oh, wow.
Man, how about that? Benson Brown, junior from Cincinnati, it's ruled incomplete. The big fella only played 2 years of high school ball and tried to make a play for his quarterback.
And he needs to hang on to this one. The big body, yeah, you've got a guy hanging all over you. That's what you, when you hear the double catch, and that one hung in there forever, thought it was going to get picked off. So you get a big gainer on first down, and then you stumble on second down. That's been the tough down for this offense. Syracuse needs to find a way to get off the field right here and get the ball back.
Orange hustle in another defensive end. Cherry in motion for the Wolfpack. Brissett going to throw. Steps up. Now looking for room. And he'll be sacked. Back at the 38, Hodge and Lynch, the new law firm in town, brings down Jacoby Brissett, loss of 4.
Marquise Hodge, a sophomore, learning well from these two backers, the seniors he's playing next to. And this is what they talk about, discipline in those rush lanes. Jacoby Brissett isn't the fastest quarterback in the nation, but he's as good as it gets when it comes to slipping out of these blitzers' hands. When they've got him locked down,
He made a couple guys miss, but when they keep coming wave after wave, eventually you're going to drop them, and that's a big stop defensively. He's a lot like a Jameis Winston. You don't see Jameis Winston sprinting up and down the field beating everybody, but they can't seem to bring him down at times.
And here's Bauman again trying to flip one over. Gravius Wright, the youngster down there, to touch it up. And he juggled it, and it kicked back out for Syracuse to about the 14-yard line. And that's where NC State was finally able to down the football, Jen, but the Wolfpack still with a 3-0 lead.
Yeah, Wes, you guys have talked about Rodman Noel and how he's been in the mix defensively for NC State. It was funny, his younger brother, Nerlens Noel, first-round draft pick in 2013, actually played here in the Carrier Dome about 2.5 weeks ago in an exhibition game with the Philadelphia 76ers. Had 12 points, 11 boards, 3 assists, 4 steals, a block. Pretty good game. And I said, all right, Rodman, the challenge has been laid down. He said, oh, yeah, if one of us does something, the other one's always got to try to do it better. We're always competing. Having a good one so far.
No question. And Irvin Phillips, the freshman who's more noted in kick returns, has carried the ball from scrimmage here in the last few weeks. In fact, that's his 20th carry in the last 5 games and change for Syracuse. You know, you talk about Rodman Noel, Nerlens Noel in Philadelphia, former Kentucky Wildcat. Jim Noel played at Boston College. Bates, that's pretty good.
That's not a bad bloodline, is it?
All under one roof? I'd say so. Long to throw, middle of the field, and looking for the third, or Ben Lewis, his wide receiver. Well, the inside receiver in that particular exchange for Tim Lester, the offensive coordinator.
A hometown fans grumbling on back-to-back plays. First, they didn't love the call on first down, the run, but you have to. You have to stick with it, and you got to try to find a way to run the football. They thought there was some interference there, and there wasn't. It's just Gravius Wright. Gravius Wright becomes more and more active. He's fun to watch in coverage there, and he's good against the run, too.
A.J. Long will be sacked. Brandon Pittman, who had 7 tackles 2 weeks ago at Louisville, fights through for his second sack of the year.
Well, both of these defensive coordinators are turning up the heat on these quarterbacks. Difference is NC State is getting home, dropping A.J. Long for another loss, just like early in that Clemson game. I think, Jan Hildreth, I think it was the talent show. Man, I think coaches across the country need to take advice from Dave Dorn and have talent shows every week. Something got into them, and they're looking good early.
Here's Riley Dixon's punt. And Bo Hines backs up off the 35, and oh, what a good play. Winfield in the open field for the Orange. Wow. Great punt cover work by Corey Winfield from St. Louis.
He's the leading special teams tackler, and here's why. Make up your mind, you're going to go make the play. What happens? Guys will break down, try to come under control, and that's when you give a guy a good returner. Those returners are always going to be good in the open field. You give them a chance to get their shoulders turned and make a move, and it's the toughest thing in football. But when you turn on the heat like that, heat-seeking missile and dropping a guy, that's Corey Winfield, just a sophomore, and he just keeps on making plays on special teams.
First down, here's a reverse. Hines has got it. Looking to throw, coming back for it, and what a hole! Couldn't hang on. I thought Austin, he collided with Brandon Reddish, the corner. It got knocked up in the air, and then I thought Austin was still going to make the play, and he couldn't hang on.
Well, the leader of this defense, Brandon Reddish, he put his head down right before he came into the frame and just caught up. It's a shame NC State couldn't pull that off, because they had a chance at an easy home run ball right there. But Brandon Reddish had his second interception of the season last weekend against Clemson. Just got beat first, but he didn't put his head down. Found a way to come back and break it up.
Here is Days. Little sprint draw from Matt Days. Picks up about 5. It'll still be third and better than half for the Wolfpack of North Carolina State. Josh Kirchland, senior from out in Plaxico, Kansas, makes the stop. And Chuck Bullock got his head down, charting the plays, seeing what works, right?
Seeing if he wants to bring 6, 7, or 8. Boy, he's not afraid to roll the dice. High risk, high reward play calls for this defense. He has some athletes that can make the plays, and he's not afraid to mix it up and bring guys from all over. Expect another blitz here, but know where they got to get. They got to get to that 45.
And we get a flag thrown.
False start.
offense. Number 50, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Tony Adams, the Wolfpack guard, freshman from Charlotte, first penalty against North Carolina State.
Huge lucky there. It looked like it might have been Cameron Lynch who timed it up. Was a little bit off. Came in a little bit early. Thought it was going to be against Syracuse. Giving him a freebie on first down. Instead, it's a third down and 11 now.
Orange coming with pressure. They flip it to Days. And look at Syracuse rally to the ball. Josh Kirkland. He wants to get in on the linebacking fun too. Back-to-back tackles by Kirkland, Jen.
Well, Wes, what did Syracuse defensive coordinator Chuck Bullitt tell us about? He said, we are ball disruption crazy. Brandon Reddish may not have gotten the turnover when he broke up that pass on the reverse, but he stopped it for the Syracuse defense. The Syracuse team puts a high emphasis on ball disruption. They said they have 12 different ways they grade each player on how they can disrupt the ball. I'm thinking Reddish got a pretty high grade for that one.
Fake punt by the Wolfpack. Jalen Samuels down the far sideline. The big fullback. At 240 pounds. NC State short snaps it with Scott Thompson.
I think there was some fire in Raleigh these past 2 weeks. Dave Dorn and company looking for their first ACC win. Wow, rolling the dice here on offense. Defensively, you make a great big stand on third down, get off the field. Now you got to rush right back out there and play some defense. Watch out for a big play. Try to go up top and hit a big one.
We're set on first down just beyond the reach of Alston. 18-yard run by Jalen Samuels. And so NC State, little gadget play. We've seen the reverse and the wide receiver on the throw down the field. Now the go for it on fourth down with the snap to the up back Samuels.
Leighton White, the special teams coordinator, and that's what you get when you get an extra week to tinker.
Yep.
When they went through the gauntlet, Wes,
yeah.
Look at the Florida State at Clemson, Boston College, and then at Louisville before they got a week off. That's a tough schedule.
Brissett under duress again, puts it up, and coming back is Days and can't hang on to it. Brissett is now 2 of his last 8 since he started 5 for 5 today. Now, James, look here. This is the key, the snap, right?
It's watching tape, and it's knowing that these guys try to heat it up and make something happen. Go ahead and play it, and it's just knowing what you're going to get from watching tape. Hey, these guys are good. They're going to come in. If we can get to the edge, and the block really isn't even there. It's just a tackle that's not made. So if you can beat one guy hoping that you get him blocked, and he wasn't even blocked, it was just an outstanding play, wanting it a little bit more to get outside right at the right time. But again, the defense stiffens for another third and long.
And Brissett to throw. They've yet to convert a third down. They will here. Marquise Valdez-Scantling, sophomore from St. Petersburg, Florida, on a crossing route. And Valdez-Scantling, his 19th catch of the year, goes 15 yards. And State finally converts a third down here in this first half. And they do it on the final play of the first quarter. Tell you what, a busy 15 minutes here in Syracuse. A little bit of everything. Hard hits, breaking the script, and just a field goal so far on the board. Central New York in our Hyundai game summary. NC State has moved the football around and leads 3-0. And both teams have found points of pressure defensively here in this first 15 minutes. State in plus territory to start the second period. And here is Shadrack Thornton picking up about 8 yards. Cameron Lynch makes the tackle. The Wolfpack, 32% of the they've been outscored 58-43 in the second quarter for Syracuse. 32% of the points they've scored all year long have come here in period two for Scott Schaefer's team.
Well, they keep giving up first downs like that. The points are going to go the way of the guys in the white unis. And they, what's been impressive is the way they've gone with the punch outside and then right up the middle, mixing it up.
Here's Thornton, first down to about the 18-yard line. North Carolina State started this ball game in high-octane tempo. Since then,
nice movement through the gearbox, so to speak, right?
Well, they still continue to move it, and there's a 1-2. Two good runs. You use the run to set up the pass, and Shadrack Thornton, you can see the vision. You can see why they like him so much. They call him the Punisher, and it also takes some finesse. It also takes some knowledge of what's going on in front of you and great vision like you saw there.
Fumble by Thornton, scooped up on the carom. He thought about lateraling to Brissett. Ends up being tackled by John Raymond and Eric Kroom back beyond behind the 30-yard line.
Well, and just like Jen told us, they find a way to disrupt that ball, get that ball out of there, going for the rock. Unfortunately for Syracuse, it bounces right back up into the hands of Thornton. It's a team, just two turnovers forced in the first three games, but 15, now make it 16 in the last five in just over one quarter. That's paying off, Jen Hildreth. Those drills that they've run at practice for defensive coordinator Chuck Bolt.
Second and very long. Brissett loops it back, and here is Greenwich's second catch of the day for the big tight end. And Zaire Franklin is a freshman from Philadelphia who knocked the ball loose a moment ago from Thornton and makes a play there on David J. Greenwich.
Yeah, and it's these guys. We saw Kirkland make a couple tackles. There's Franklin. Got to have somebody on there, because that's a play that was busted from the beginning. The back went the wrong way. Jacoby turned around. There's nobody to fake to. Just rolled out. Fortunately, again, he had his big tight end there waiting on it, but it's a third down and forever now.
Well, you talked about it at the top. Great size, 6'5", David Greenwich, and penalty marker and another penalty on the Wolfpack.
All start, offense, number 71, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Alex Barr. Second penalty on NC State. Greenwich on that Mackey list, James, and you start looking, the numbers may not get you, but boy, what an efficient, complete game this kid's got.
Well, and how about the tight ends across the ACC? Serenay,
oh, yeah.
A freshman at Wake Forest. Bucky Hodges at Virginia Tech. Just a sophomore.
Clyde Walford at Miami.
These penalties, Wes. These penalties, you're moving it, and then on third down, you can't have these little five-yarders killing.
Brissett going to throw and into the seats. So now fourth down, and Sadie will try a field goal, and Dave Doran wants to talk to his quarterback. Not happy at all, I don't believe, with the selection there. Sadie hit in the first period from 43. This is 43. 7 of 11 on the year. And the kick is good.
Sadie's kick is good from 33 yards away.
So Nicholas Sadie catches his name in the Wolfpack record books. 51 career field goals. 6-0 State, second quarter after this. Second quarter here at the Carrier Dome. Family weekend on the campus of Syracuse University. Mr. Wolf is here, and so are some NC State fans as well, to see if the Pack can snap a four-game skid. And Nicholas Sadie, who just became NC State's all-time leader in field goals made with 51, passing the great Mike Kofer. And he'll kick it over the top of Prince Tyson Gully. And the Orange will start from its 25. Our Hooters news and notes for week 10 in the ACC. We're still recapping Thursday night. 21-7 at the half. Jameis Winston goes Jameis Winston in the second half.
Just like he did, he go Jameis Winston in the second half against Notre Dame. He was perfect in those last two.
How about my last note there? 11 of 14 schools have four or more conference games remaining. The impact November could have, you've been talking about since week two or three that Duke won the Coastal last year. Really, in about the final minute of the regular season, it could very well happen again.
Well, Duke won a tough one on the road in Pittsburgh today. Wow.
A.J. Long will be sacked. Art Norman, Rodman Noel, Thomas Teal. And the Wolfpack is finding their way through that beat-up Syracuse offensive line.
It was the second wave, so it wasn't the first Noel. It was Art Norman and company. Noel got through there just to kind of slow him up. And what's going on here?
is the coverage. In the secondary, NC State, there's just nowhere to go for A.J. Long. They're blanketing those receivers.
There's Long. Zips it inside.
Look at the angles.
Daniel Lewis the catch, and it'll be third and about 8 yards.
You can have that all day. Watch, as soon as this pass is complete, watch him convert. Watch him come. Boom, boom. Vice angles. Man, that's pretty. That is a well-coached defensive unit on that play right there. And time again, they have been disciplined in those rush lanes. It's a good secondary. Good play today so far.
Here's Long, third and eight, and tried to go back across the middle of Lewis. He collided with Jones. That's Josh Jones, a redshirt freshman, playing in that strong safety position. And the Orange will go three and out for a third straight possession.
It's been a defense, West, that has come out. The opening drive, as you mentioned, NC State just started rolling on down the field, but they stiffened, and they've looked good the last couple times, giving up a few yards. Offense needs to help them out, or they're going to get tired.
Lions will wave off Dixon's punt, and it'll back up on the Orange there. And it is touched up, so NC State will play at about its 46-yard line. Just a 25-yard punt. Oh, how about the pumpkin? A little conference logo. ACC football is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the Atlantic Coast Conference. AT&T, Geico, Ruby Tuesday, and by the New York Life Insurance Company. Now, James, I know in the Southeast there's a place called the Varsity.
Right.
Kind of famous for some things.
There in Atlanta.
Up here, Marshall Street, the Varsity. Well, this is what this is famous for, right here. An extra cheese, please.
Let me have the head to the Varsity. I was thinking dinosaur barbecue.
Yeah, you're looking for a little drive-by to Varsity, aren't you? NC State, after the defense, forces Syracuse into a third straight three and out. The Wolfpack starts at the 49, and first man through Shad Thornton a couple of yards. Look at here. Field goals bookend their four possessions. The 9:52 in the field goal on the opening possession was the high tempo job, and then since then, they've huddled occasionally, and here is Braylon Cherry breaking free down the far sideline. Cherry, who had some big catches, five of them at Louisville a couple of weeks ago, does some damage here, Batesy.
Well, and so many times, that's why I say eventually you're just going to get tired. You're going to let off a play, and then they're going to hit a big one on you. This is just what happens. Cherry keeps on churning, and it's a defense that's got to be tired the way the offense has been quick off the field each and every time.
We got a timeout for injury here at the Carrier Dome. 6-0 NC State. Well, they finally got Big John Raymond to the bench area for Syracuse. The young man did not play in the first four games of the season. He's come back, and you
watch Thornton. Thornton, see his helmet come in here, and it hits the thigh. So let's just hope, Wes, it's just a deep thigh kind of thing. It's almost a high-low because the offensive lineman Chandler was engaged.
29-yard play it was to Cherry, and here's the Wolfpack. And Days, a yard or two. Finish the thought on Raymond. He was injured, lost for the year at Georgia Tech a season ago in Atlanta in a 56-0 loss for the Orange. James, he worked back, rehab from that injury, didn't play the first four games, sat out the Louisville game, but played three ball games, and let's hope it's not bad. Here's Brissett keeping it to the far side, and he'll step out of bounds, and a marker thrown in as he had reached the white. And that'll be a first down and half the distance after the marker there.
After the play is over, personal foul. Unnecessary roughness, number six, half the distance to the goal. First down.
Richie DeSeer of Syracuse guilty. And the Wolfpack is in the CPI security red zone here.
Well, along with getting tired comes frustration. And frustration and silly penalties to aid in an offense that has moved this ball, even though they're only up 6-0, pretty well here in the first half with 9:30 remaining before halftime.
Days on sweep to the left side, and the Orange pursue it well. Brandon Reddish, the corner, fights all the way through to pull down. it's well done. 2 yard loss on the play.
And this is what is very tough to do. When you swing it out, when you throw it, a now pass or something, they're already out there. But when you try to outrun these backers, even though Davis peels off, can't bring him down, you've got guys fighting on the outside. When you've got Cameron Lynch outside on one side, Dyshawn Davis on the other, they're smart football players. They're fast football players, and they take good angles. And that's a nice defensive play.
Tyler Purvis in motion. Brissett going to keep it. Jacoby Brissett trying to work back through traffic inside the five and brought down around the four, maybe the 3 yard line. Darius Kelly was there, Cameron Lynch, and a host of orange.
A little bit of talking there at the end, too. Mm-hmm. Darius Kelly getting fired up. And we talk about frustrating. Jacoby Brissett, he just when you think you've got him dropped, he just finds a way to get a couple more on you and make something positive out of nothing.
Well, there's offensive coordinator Matt Canada upstairs, and Dave Doran and the Wolfpack bang a timeout here. And there is a good look at the 42-year-old native of Shawnee Mission, Kansas. 93 graduate of Drake and, of course, captain Northern Illinois, coach Northern Illinois to a MAC championship and a BCS at large berth in the Orange Bowl. Went 23-4 in two seasons with the Huskies. Worked at Wisconsin, Kansas, Montana, grad assistant at Southern Cal. And I like his intensity, James. We were talking earlier today. I just like everything he's done in the 2 years to try and rebuild the foundation of NC State. But he knows it's a production business, too.
Well, off the field as well. The highest team GPA in 15 years there in Raleigh. It's one of the youngest teams in the nation, and it's frustrating, especially when it starts to build. This would be, in his two seasons, Dave Doran's first ACC win.
Right.
That's a little bit of pressure. Not anything they're thinking about right now, obviously. Right now, all they're thinking about is trying to get it 4 yards into the paint on a third down and goal.
Two tights to the left this time. Brissett going to throw. Valdez Scantling can't get there with Reddish defending for Syracuse. So now on fourth down, Sadie will have to try another field goal.
I've enjoyed watching tape of Brandon Reddish. He fights, giving up a lot of height there to the 6'3" Marquez Valdez Scantling. Right side, it's just one-on-one. Nobody else out there to help you. Just fighting, fighting, fighting. What's important as a defensive back, as a corner, you can't let any space at all. You got to feel that body of the receiver on you. It's perfectly played.
And Sadie kicks his third field goal to the first half. And Nicholas Sadie makes it a 9-0 NC State lead on a 21-yard field goal. So the Wolfpack defense has forced three straight three and outs. And the field goal gives away. Oh, now, hang on a second here. Jen, I had no idea. We heard about the Georgia-Florida Hall of Fame in Jacksonville yesterday. And they gave you, you got a bust? Talia and Georgia got to go too?
Yeah, Georgia went out for the coin toss to represent the Bates family today too. So, yeah, what a special day and a dream come true to play in that rivalry, yeah. And then to be a part of something forever in that Hall of Fame. Wes, it was a special day, and thanks to the team for letting me roll in here a little bit late last night. And it's a really, really proud. But
what's
Christina,
that?
Christina and graphics, it's the Florida Georgia rivalry, not the Georgia Florida rivalry. Let's get that straight.
Hey, Jen, to me, it's James Bates, HOF from here on out.
That's right. But what's up, Batesy? Come on, your daughter's name is Georgia, and she's the one you have go out for the coin toss? No irony there for you, right?
Well, here's the deal. Had we gone 0-4 against the Bulldogs, we probably wouldn't have named her Georgia. And my wife, they went 4-0. She was a swimmer at Florida, an All-American.
Yeah.
And they never lost to Georgia. So it was prophetic. We never had any problems with Georgia or with baby Georgia. She's a sweet little girl.
Wow.
Yeah,
boy, even at your age now, you still poke the bear of the Bulldogs a little bit, don't you?
Oh, you have to. I had some fun in there yesterday with my little speech. I absolutely had to, and it was so much fun. And I just, again, just such an honor. And thanks to you guys. Thanks to the truck for putting that up there.
Congratulations to you. Congratulations to your family as well. I know it's a big day.
All right. Thank you very much.
Yeah, that's great. James Bates in the Florida, Georgia Hall of Fame.
There you go, Wes. Yeah. Now we can be friends again.
Orange from the 25 and Tyson Gully, Prince Tyson Gully. Picks up about 9 on first down, a marker down behind the play. And this young man from Akron, Ohio, now a grad student here for the Orange, is our hearty star to watch as he's gone over 500 yards rushing. Just part of a committee of backs for Scott Schaefer's team.
Had 138 yards on the ground against Maryland in the loss here. And he's so important today, Wes. He has got to have some success to just give A.J. Long and company a little bit of cushion, a little bit of room to operate. That defense has to respect the run. And there you see the 7 carries already today, and that's most of that 17 was on the first play from scrimmage.
Yep, holding call there. Backs up Syracuse again. And now they fire it to the perimeter. Breaking free is Jared West.
We talked about Jacoby Brissett having a security blanket in his big tight end. You know your cousin's got your back if you're A.J. Long, and this is the reason that Dave Doran called that timeout on third down and goal. This is the reason why you can't continue to just settle for 3 points, because Syracuse has some guys that can make big plays like this.
Big strike, 35 yards. Long ropes it again, incomplete. And threw it behind. His cousin, Jared. Top 10 now in receptions at Syracuse and closing in on the same status in receiving yards as West. You talk about being a top 10 receiver at this institution, you're talking about a list that's pretty good. So it's second down and 10 for the young freshman from Lebanon, Tennessee. And here's Gully on the read play. And Prince Tyson will pick up about 4.5 yards. But a moment ago, A.J. Long dials it up.
Well, here's West outside, and watch, you're going to see some help on West. It's not single coverage. The safeties are going to come over the corner, rather, and they've got the angles up there. Should have been a 5-yard gain. Instead, a secondary that has been crisp, has been sharp on those angles. Somebody slips up, and it's off to the races.
A.J. Long checked it all the way down. Devontae McFarland out of the backfield. Knocked out of bounds. And McFarland shaking up on the play. Jared Fernandez, the redshirt freshman at linebacker, made the hit. We get a stoppage of play here as they tend to the injured McFarland. And there's a look at Devontae McFarland.
Timeout on the field.
And we'll step aside while they tend to the junior running back of the Orange. 9-0 NC State. Well, as you can see, Syracuse is trying to break a bit of a drought offensively. And they were able to move the ball out past midfield. But out of the injury timeout from McFarland, they have snapped the 3 straight 3 and outs. And A.J. Long with a nice pass to Jared West. And we're going to look at Riley Dixon here. The punt. Hines signals 4 and makes the good catch just inside the 8-yard line. James, you brought up a point a minute ago. I think pretty important here. If Long gets into rhythm, could be trouble with those field goals instead of touchdowns. How about we don't know real sure yet. We might be here at the Cary Dome. We might be at Carter Finley Stadium in Raleigh for the Yellow Jackets and North Carolina State, or the Blue Devils, who won in double overtime today in Pittsburgh. On the visit to the Cary Dome.
The drama, not just on the field, but in my closet. I'm trying to decide what tie to wear. This is really cramping my style. You talk about those field goals, Wes.
Right.
And remember back Thursday night, not as many points scored, but Louisville and Florida State. It was a domination by Louisville in the first half.
first, but then at the very end, Florida State goes in and scores and zaps all that momentum. If the Syracuse defense can get another stop here and they can go down and get a touchdown, this is a whole new football game in a game that has really belonged to NC State the entire first half. But they've got to stiffen right here with under 6 minutes to play to give their offense a chance in what should be the best field position of the day.
Yep. So a pretty big couple of snaps here for the Orange on defense in particular. And here's Tony Creasy. And he'll be just shy of the 15. It'll leave him about, leave him at North Carolina State, NC State now, and it's third down offense has struggled here a little bit. Only one of seven today, and James against the league, they're 37.5%.
Dyshawn Davis on that last play, smart football player. To show you how smart, he had his hands wrapped in that face mask and quickly took them off to avoid getting a penalty flag thrown. So here's a third down and four and a chance to get off the field.
Brissett throws and caught. Braylon Cherry. Boy, how many big catches have we seen Cherry make at Louisville a couple of weeks ago and here in this first half?
How about Brissett to roll and watch? It's going to be 35 eventually on this coverage. He's sitting right down there in the window, but it's Cherry. And when you thread the needle like that, you move the chains out in coverage, Dyshawn Davis.
Here's Hines trying to break through. A pretty good hit at the 25. A couple of yards for Bo Hines. Darrell Eskridge, who you'll learn more about coming up at the half with Jen Hildreth, makes the play for Syracuse.
Here comes that tempo again for NC State here, Wes.
Brissett going to loop for Cherry, makes the catch at midfield ahead of Julian Wiggum. So Brissett and Cherry starting to find rhythm, James.
Little back shoulder Wiggum. See him, see me. See those eyes. Those eyes get big, Wiggum. Snap that head around. Snap that head around. He's in perfect position. Just got it. That's the space I was talking about down at the other end as a cornerback.
Hines back to the line of scrimmage out in space on the far side with Reddish defending.
Good job there to bring the angles by the defense, but those receivers' eyes are going to get big for a reason. Wide when that ball's almost there in good position, you got to finish plays off.
Reset, quick snap, now overthrows Bo Hines.
They're changing just about everybody. The hockey line changed shape. They play some hockey up here in upstate New York. Line changes, they just don't come over the boards here on this third down and long.
They're trying to get the penalty kill unit out there, isn't he? Third and 10 here for the Wolfpack. 2 of 8 today on third down.
Know where those sticks are. Cherry curled up right at the first down marker last time. Know where they're trying to get.
Brissett hit as he throws, incomplete. Dyshawn Davis. Boy, these linebackers are really good for the Orange, James.
They back out of it in the middle and bring two off the edge. Dyshawn Davis on that series. There you see in the middle, it's Hodge that backs out into coverage. Davis is going to finish it off. Watching Dyshawn Davis on that series alone, we saw him stuff the run in the middle. We saw him in pass coverage. We saw him sprint outside and make a play on a little receiver in open field. And then we saw with the huge sack to get off the field. Dyshawn Davis is a great linebacker.
Bauman checks another one up inside the five. And boy, wow. Travis Wright down there again. Great punt cover work again by the Wolfpack, and Syracuse will start inside its five. Don't forget, check your local listings this week's edition of ACC All Access. Miss Hildreth will have a full half hour for you. The latest action, not only in football, but wrapping up soccer and other campaigns here in the month of November. So join Jen for another edition of ACC All Access. Coming up this week, check your local listings for the time in your market.
Wes, this Will Bauman, he's the MVP so far. I mean, you know, plenty of time with 3:38 for A.J. Long, but as a freshman, and you've got to stand on your own goal line, it just changes the whole outlook here on this offensive series.
Well, and here's the big 235-pound Adonis Amin Moore carrying the ball for a couple of yards, and Jen Dravius Wright there makes another stop for the Pack.
Well, Wes, we knew one of the issues for Syracuse coming into today were injuries. Two guys now have gotten word will be out for the rest of the game on defense. John Raymond, nose tackle, you saw him go down. He's out, the lower body injury, as is Nick Robinson, right guard, out for the game.
And as we come back to live action, Amin Moore and Justin Burris saves that from being a bigger play.
That's a big old tailback, switched to fullback last year, and now he's back at the tailback position in a nice play call here. They spread out the field and run a draw out of there to move the chains. Still with two timeouts, plenty of time, just under 3 minutes.
There's the third straight carry for the senior from Denver, Colorado, and Art Norman for State wraps up Amin Moore. Converted fullback, who started out as a running back, went to fullback, and now has come back as Adonis Amin Moore. Over 300 yards now in the campaign for him. Under 2.5 to go, and A.J. Long in the orange. Well, it may not have gone their way some of this half. They're not completely gone yet. Here's Long to throw, and Lewis kind of working the route off too soon. Steve Ishmael was the deep receiver, another freshman from Miami, whose brother's a member of the Atlanta Falcons and was the former Conference USA Defensive Player of the Year at Central Florida. Come on, Ishmael.
Well, you heat it up on second down, and an obvious passing down when you're trying to do anything to get some points on the board before halftime. And knowing that it's coming, they roll out A.J. Long. But good coverage by this Wolfpack secondary again.
Orange 1-6 on third down. Long and incomplete. And now a late flag thrown in, intended for Adrian Fleming. And Niles Clark was the State player in coverage. And Jeff Heaser.
Pass interference. Defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
The redshirt sophomore Clark guilty there. And Orange pick up a first via penalty.
Well, first downs have been tough to come by for this Orange offense, and that's bailing them out a little bit right there. Again, good coverage for Niles Clark. The young sophomore's got to trust his feet and trust his instincts. Keep those hands off the receiver.
Long fake the read option play to Gully, and then Mike Rose drops him behind the line now. Boy, Rose played very well a couple of weeks ago at Louisville and gets a nice stop here.
So much they brought the heavyweight title belt back out. Every single snap, whether it's a four-man rush, three-man rush, or they're bringing 6-5, these guys are getting off the ball and putting pressure on those offensive linemen in that backfield. Look at them here.
Another pressure again. Long steps out of it. Going to try and throw back, and it's caught. Josh Paris, the tight end from outside of Atlanta at Stevenson High School, makes the play. Not enough for a first down, but boy, NC State still bringing the pressure. It's a 13-yard throw here.
Boy, had him dead to rights, almost drop him, and that's the scrappiness that they like about the true freshman. Now you want to see him snap it right now. Get it rolling and keep them on their heels.
Long looking down the field. What a catch. Jared West hauls in another one from the rookie. And you can tell AJ's feeling it a little bit here now, James.
Cousins. Oh, how about the throw? Beautiful catch. Getting a little bit of space at the very last moment, but the throw was absolutely beautiful.
Boy, what a momentum builder this would be for Schaefer in the orange here. Long looking to throw. And this is Steve Ishmael to catch. Down near another first down at the 20. And A.J. Long is ripping it now.
Little bit of time that time, and look at him drop it in. Safety coming over the top, trying to help. And underneath, Justin Burris seemed to be in perfect position with the big 6'3", 210-pound receiver. A.J. Long's cousin goes up and makes the biggest play of this first half for the Orange.
So A.J. Long, this young freshman, 6 feet tall, 177 pounds, and they may have skewed the measurements a little bit on AJ. He's 7 of 13 for 114 in this first half, Jen, and a couple times it's been Cousin Jared making the big play. And Jared West.
And Wes, we found out where did AJ Long often wind up when he was a youngster. He'd come visit. He'd often wake up on the couch in Jared West's apartment. He said, oh, you know, I just wanted to go hang out with my cousin. Knew he wanted to come here, loved it here. And you know what? Jared West was a quarterback in high school. It's one of the reasons AJ wanted to be a quarterback. Jared switched to receiver. Now it's just, hey, get me the ball, cuz.
Unbelievable, huh?
Couldn't wait to get here. Graduated early, and it's paying off. And you know another thing? That's the throw that he's had a little bit of trouble with, those, putting it in the windows in the zone coverage, growing up there on that one and trying to put some points on the board before half.
Long's gonna throw here, middle of the field, and Ismail, the intended receiver, and broken up. The Wolfpack's Jack Tocho, outstanding sophomore corner from Charlotte, who came into the contest with 29 hits and a pick, provided the physical play there. And now third down for Schaefer's Orange.
Tried to force that one there. You don't want a field goal here. It's been so tough to move the ball. Finally, you get some momentum, a little bit of rhythm.
10th play of the drive coming up here for the Orange. You see NC State trying to get their personnel set.
Remember, this is a guy that can go west. Be careful of those quarterback draws, a design quarterback run with the defense spread out.
There he goes. And A.J. Long picks up about half of it to the 15. Arius Moore, who played a great ball game 2 weeks ago, is a starter at Louisville. And look here, Syracuse has gotten enough for the first down. And here's the Orange with 28 seconds left in the clock running. 11th play coming up. You see that's gone 80 yards in 3 minutes and a timeout.
Third timeout, Syracuse.
Interesting here. You talk about momentum for the Orange. Conversely, a stop for the Wolfpack here just fuels the first half they've had.
Well, it absolutely does. And this score is not indicative of the first half that the Wolfpack has had. Defensively, they have been outstanding with the exception of this drive, letting them get a couple first downs here and a couple big plays finally. But offensively as well, the 9 points, it really could be about 20 points, 17 points at least, but the Orange defense has stiffened when they've needed to. They've made some big plays when they had to, but all that will change with 7 points put on the board, a lot like the other night in Louisville. It was a first half that just belonged to Bobby Petrino's team, but that late drive and that late score just totally turned the table.
A couple of times you've already mentioned cashing a touchdown for a field goal sometimes. NC State had, what, 3 first downs inside the 20? Come away with field goals and not touchdowns. Well,
and didn't Dave Doran know? It's third down and goal, I believe, from the 3 just a few moments ago when he called that timeout. That's when they felt like, hey, we can get a mismatch here with the height. But it was just such a good defensive play by Brandon Reddish to force that field goal try. Let's see what they got on first down now.
The young rookie takes a snap from the gun. They push the pocket. Long fires it out of bounds.
Hit a high schooler.
Well, they had it leveled. Looks like they had the receiving package leveled out for him. You know, from maybe 10 yards to about 20 yards. But Long's had a pretty good first half. James, they really haven't asked him to do anything he's not capable of, I guess.
Well, and on that first play, just avoiding the blitz, he was dropped the play before by this hard-charging front line of NC State. And look at him. Just a freshman, but a leader already. They talk about how a lot of guys on this team look up to him, and he's barking there.
And he'll fire and caught. Lewis. Touchdown. Ben Lewis. What a great grab. Gotta go a long way to find one this good, don't you?
Welcome back, Sweet Lou. The pressure from Fernandez. AJ Long
is a completed pass for a touchdown. That play is under further review.
The ball is absolutely perfect. Perfect when the receiver is on his feet, when he is basically parallel with this turf. it turns into one of the most incredible catches we've seen on the year. Ben Lewis looks to be banged up a little bit. He missed the Wake game and the Clemson game. They need to keep, wow, look at the hands here, the concentration to pull that in. And here's what they're going to look at as the very end. And his hand absolutely looks to go underneath the ball. And remember, on the field, this is ruled a touchdown, and it absolutely should stay that way.
Jeff Heaser's on the headset. But this is some kind of catch by Ben Lewis.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
And what a momentum build for Schaefer's Orange. That's a big time catch, James. That's a big time catch.
And it's some desire. It's the kind that you need from a football team just desperately fighting to try to get their fourth win of the season and get in some sort of bowl picture. Wow, what a big touchdown after you had been skunked time and time again. But the freshman continues to fight, gets hit right as he lets go of this football. Bam, a shot from Fernandez, and laying out like that and able to tuck it in. A little bit of want-to for 84 and company. And look at this. All the momentum in the Carrier Dome is on this home team sideline right now.
12 plays, 96 yards, and 323. And A.J. Long throws his third touchdown. And the Orange, who had three straight possessions of three and out, punted the ball on their first five possessions. Man, you talk about two scoops of momentum going to the locker room. And Dave Doran's Wolfpack, who have kind of controlled the ball game for the most part. Now, Syracuse has played well defensively, but we're having a hard time finding anything on offense. Now, all of a sudden, NC State had a 9-0 lead, felt pretty good about their situation. Now they're going to go to the locker room, and who knows what the second half will be.
You go back a couple weeks ago, Syracuse at Wake Forest. And Wake Forest right now, offensively, doesn't really have those big play guys that really scare you. There are a few. When you look at guys like Prince Tyson Gully, when you look at Jared West, NC State, that's why I'm saying you can't settle for these field goals, because they have some big play threats, and you saw it on that drive.
Ball got scooped up and pushed back is... And Tim Buckley is the up man for the Wolfpack. He got knocked back around the 30-yard line. ACC Gridiron Live. Oh, my heavens. Bates, Crumpler, Grobe, Wire. All the highlights, all the interviews, all the breakdowns, and, yes, folks, all the picks. Presented by McAllister's Deli.
No, we have a good time.
Who's winning the picks now?
Coach Grobe. Coach Grobe's winning the picks. Yep. Algie picked North Carolina today, though. Another beef with Christina. It's Florida, Georgia, and I would like to have that James Bates highlighted a little bit. Just kind of dance. Can we do that?
Halftime at the Carrier Dome, and Schaefer's Orange get a touchdown throw, 15 yards. A.J. Long to Ben Lewis. And Syracuse trails just a couple of points. Going to the locker room, and Jen has got Scott Schaefer.
Thanks, Wes. Coach, it's one way to get some momentum going in the locker room. What did you like about that drive from your offense?
Well, I thought A.J. made some plays with his feet, extended it out. Great catch by Benny there. I like them, the fact that we're trying to find some fire. You know, we got three puppies there inside, center guard, center. We tried to play the kids that were hurt. They're struggling. They're not going to be able to go. So some new faces have got to get it done here in the second half. That's all there is to it.
Well, you got a good start going into the half. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
All right, Jen. Schaefer's team to within two at the break. Stay tuned. Full halftime coming up from the Carrier Dome. ACC football is brought to you by Blimpy and by Hyundai.
Our ACC college football Saturday halftime is brought to you by Hyundai. A little rainy outside, but perfectly fine here inside the Carrier Dome as the NC State Wolfpack have the two-point lead. NC State had three field goals first half, but Syracuse snatched the momentum with a big touchdown just before before the halftime break. Hey guys, I'm Jen Hildreth. I'll be taking you through halftime here from the Carrier Dome. And while we've got a great matchup right here in Central New York, let's take a look at some of the other games going around the ACC today. There were some big ones. Of course, the week started with that impressive win by Florida State over Louisville. Look at Boston College, two-point winners over Virginia Tech. Tyler Murphy with a big game. Georgia Tech is up on Virginia. How about Duke and Pittsburgh? These two teams get together. All of a sudden, we're scoring 100 points or close to it. Wow, Duke escaping in overtime, double overtime. Thomas Serk's second touchdown run of the day got the win. And then Miami, big winners over North Carolina. A lot of damage on the ground. 295 yards rushing. Duke Johnson had a 90-yard touchdown run, longest run of his career.
9-7 NC State. They must have heard you were here today. He's wearing 44 and everything.
And DJ. He just went from Sugar Hill Gang to Rob Bass. It takes two, and it's a lead by two.
Indeed it is with James Bates, West Durham. We can show you halftime stats here between NC State and Syracuse, but they don't really tell you the story. Here are the numbers, the facts and filaments, if you will, but the momentum is what this ballgame's been about.
Absolutely right. A big capital M, momentum. Look at the total yards. 138 total yards for Syracuse. Well, 96 came on that last drive, a drive that resulted in the 7 points, their only score of the day. And it's been a Syracuse defense that, in between the 20s, has given up some plays and has let NC State roll a little bit, but they've tightened things up when they got down in the red zone and held the 3 field goals. This is going to be one heck of a second half because Syracuse gets the opening kick.
Well, you see those combined third downs, 5 of 17 between the two. 9-7 pack. Orange get the ball when we come back. Touchdown pass long to Lewis at the end of the first half has put the Orange on the board, and Dave Doran's team will kick to Syracuse to start half number two at the Carrier Dome. Scott Schaefer's club, he told Jen going to the locker room, we're playing with three puppies at guard, center guard. Young fellas having to take over. Robinson, the guard, couldn't go. Trudeau banged up as well today. So was Miller. See how it plays for the young freshman Long. And the kick by Sadie bounces back about 8 yards deep. And here is Jen with the Wolfpack head coach.
Thanks, Wes. Coach, your team did a pretty good job moving the ball there in the first half, but you had to settle for 3 instead of 6. How do you switch that in?
Well, we had the ball 17 minutes and gave up only 60 yards. You don't feel like it when you look at the scoreboard. So obviously, we got to continue to stop them defensively. Had a couple plays, you know, pass interference and then a big play behind us. And offensively, we need to score some points. We need to get in the end zone, finish some drives. That's what it's all about, is finishing.
Thanks, Coach.
And here is Long to Jared West. And about 8 on first down. Hakeem or Josh Jones, the safety in that 2-4-5 of NC State, or 4-2-5 of NC State, makes the play.
Well, Wes, Coach Doran talked about finishing for Syracuse. It's starting hot and capitalizing on some of that momentum, because there was none coming out of the Clemson game and not much in the first half.
Prince Tyson Gully almost stepped through the tackle of Arius Moore, and that'll be just enough for the first down. And here's what you're talking about. The first half, first 5 possessions, not good. That last drive was special, though.
138 total, 96. The big number that last drive.
Here's Gully sweeping, and he will try and stretch back to the 35 and make it a loss of just 1 on the play. Mike Rose, Dravius Wright stretched the play out. Well, that's good scouting and preparation by Dave Huxtable, their defensive coordinator.
It is, and what's going on here, if you can sustain these drives, made a point there at the beginning of that last drive for Syracuse of how sharp and how good getting off the spot this defensive front was for NC State, but they started to tire. Running them sideline to sideline will continue that.
And Long's pass batted away. Jack Tocho intended for Ben Lewis. A.J. Long's first half look.
Well, and this all coming late. This is that last drive. Almost sacked, comes back across the middle, and here's the big one to his cousin. Biggest play of the game. Beautifully thrown ball and a nice catch. And capped off with that great layout by Ben Lewis. Throwing back here, trying to come underneath. There's going to be a flag thrown here because Justin Burris continued to run, trying to get back. There was West, and A.J. Long is banged up a little bit.
Yeah, Long may have taken a shot there.
Pass interference, defense, number 11, 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Long still feeling the effects. Fourth penalty on the Wolfpack.
And again,
hand to hand here.
Well,
James.
And we've seen guys in good position. That's as good as it gets with your feet. Now trust your feet. Here's a hit at the end. And Long staying in the game.
Hands the ball. This is Adonis Amin Moore. Remember, he had a couple of nice runs on that touchdown drive. Kentavious Street makes the play. Amari Palmer is the injured player for the Orange. Boy, the last thing Syracuse needs is an injury in the offensive line. But Palmer, the big 300-pound redshirt junior, Coram, New York, is shaken up on the play. And he'll be tended to.
Timeout on the field.
While they tend to Amari Palmer, we'll step aside. Early second half at the Carrier Dome. Syracuse, after Palmer helped off the field, taking this opening possession to plus territory. That's the injured Orange quarterback, Terrell Hunt, on the headset upstairs with the OC, Tim Lester. He's Coach Hunt now for the remainder of the season. And good to be, yeah, we got you on the TV, Terrell, don't worry.
I'm glad they pointed it out to him. That was a good smile. It was a nice young man, enjoyed visiting with me.
And then he's counseling Long here when the defense goes on the field. He stays on Channel B, as Tim Lester told us yesterday.
He's charting these plays, and interesting because he gets to see it from up here, and it's totally changed his perspective. And so hoping they get another shot with him as a quarterback around here. But right now, it's up to the true freshman.
Here's Long carrying the football, and he'll have the first down for the Orange at the 35 of NC State. And Jen, I don't know how much Coach Hunt helped Long, but that was a pretty good play there.
He may take some credit for it, Wes. I don't know, but it's great to see Terrell doing something positive. Jim Lester told us the first game that Hunt was out, he said he wanted him up there with him. Terrell didn't really know what he wanted. Now he loves it. He wants to be up there and says he is seeing the game a different way.
Also said it's a lot slower up there than it is on the field. And here is Prince Tyson Gully out of the backfield. About 5 yards on first down. Rodman Noel makes the play. You can almost see the confidence starting to build with the young freshman here.
Well, it's the momentum. It's the rhythm that's carried over from the first half. You know, and Terrell Hunt, it was funny. He said, now I see what Coach is talking about. They stand over the ball forever. They want tempo. They want tempo. You feel like you're going fast, but it's just not fast enough.
Trailing two. And thrown behind the intended receiver, Steve Ishmael. So A.J. Long and Syracuse built this momentum late in the first half on a 15-yard strike to Lewis, James. And here's the major, this is the way we saw the play initially.
Right, absolutely looks like a catch. But and very quick to come back and say it was a catch. Now watch this. Watch this ball. So maybe it's momentum, some sneaky momentum. Not sure about that second angle right there, Wes. What do you think? That's a tough one, but they were quick to come back and say it was a touchdown.
Here's Long being pressured, and he'll scurry up the field and step out of bounds near an Orange first down for A.J. Long. Farrell McKeever pushed him out. A.J. Long just continuing to make plays here, Jen.
Yeah, and you know what? We talked about his cousin, Jared West. Well, I heard Jared West say that A.J.'s nickname, A.J. Freestyle. We can see it here, can't we?
Absolutely. Another first down for Syracuse. 12 of them now in the ballgame for the Orange, and seemingly most of them in the last two possessions. Long going to throw to the end zone and caught. Steve Ismail, a touchdown. Third touchdown catch of the year for the freshman Ismail.
Watch A.J. freestyle, put this up there in the connection, come back underneath, and no question about this one, but again, great use of the hands, great concentration by another Miami kid. Scott Schaefer has built such a trust and such a pipeline with kids from Miami, Florida. We saw the special piece at halftime on Eskridge. Here they are offensively getting it done, too. Wow, what a big opening drive in the second half for the Orange.
Last two possessions, the Orange have gone on touchdown marches, and they've ended with touchdown passes from the rookie, A.J. Long. This one to fellow freshman, Steve Ismail. ACC football is brought to you by Honda Generators and by Hardee's Texas Barbecue Thick Burger. Oh, yeah. Need something in orange? I can take you to a spot.
I like that one hat with the S on it.
Yeah, they've got several versions. Carrier Dome. Temperatures dipping below 50 up here in central New York. Starting to get that little fall edge in November. And the Orange have taken the lead for the first time today. Second TD pass in the afternoon for A.J. Long. And Days off the goal line. And Matt Days fumbled the ball, scooped up, and recovered. I think Braylon Cherry's back on it for NC State. Markers everywhere.
Might be an illegal wedge where they're throwing right there. Wow, what a big lick.
Josh Kirkland.
Fortunately for NC State, they get it back. Great coverage every time down.
During the return, holding 19, the receiving team, half the distance to the goal, first down.
So, fifth penalty of the day against the Wolfpack. Coming right at you, Batesy.
Good coverage on one of the better return men in the ACC, just blowing it up right there. A whole lot of want to for the guys with the orange bonnets on. And shoot, we saw a couple times this year, and we've had the Wolfpack. Days has been a big difference. That's why special teams play. NC State has done a great job of just kicking out of the back of the end zone each time.
Jacoby Brissett hadn't touched the football since he had a 9-0 lead. And here is Shad Thornton. Picking up about 5 on first down. Toward the 9 goes Thornton. Eric Kroom. Cam Lynch. And Doran's team with their first chance to possess the ball. You see the numbers that have kind of plagued State since putting up 41 and a loss to Florida State. Just 9 here today, and he's as frustrated as anybody else about the red zone chances that have ended in field goals. And now Thornton trapped behind the line. Maybe a loss of 1 on the play. It'll be 3rd and long. Ron Thompson, redshirt sophomore from just outside Detroit. Big 13 in there.
Watch him get low. Look at Kroom just walk back that guard, Schooley, into the backfield. Penetration kills whatever you want to do to a defense. One more play, and the Carrier Dome is going to get cranking loud in here. All the momentum right now with Syracuse. Can they get one more big step?
Brissett puts Greenwich's big tight end wide left. top of your screen. They'll throw to the far side. This is Thornton, and broke away from Eskridge, but then the rest of the blue shirts showed up. And that's three and out for the Orange on defense for the first time today.
Well, we talked about it earlier. Open field, go make that play. Breaking down, coming under control, and just gone from the very beginning. If it didn't happen there, there was a missed block right behind. Richie Desir beat his blocker, and boom, here comes those backers just gobbling it up. Huge three and out for this defense.
Will Bauman will have to hammer this one. Almost got there, but here's Desir at the 48 of NC State. Near side, and Dravius Wright again with a great play on special teams. 48-yard punt by Bauman, and Dravius Wright again doing an outstanding job in punt cover. But A.J. Long's the story here, James.
Well, throws it. Again, good coverage. The corner, and these cornerbacks have said it way too many times. It's just they've been in good position. It's not like they're flat out getting beat. They've just got to be disciplined. And Coach Dorham was talking about finishing. Well, finishing goes for defense too. It goes for every play, not just the drive. You got to finish. Your feet are in good position. You're right in the hip pocket. Watch those eyes. Trust those instincts. Stuff that I know every single defensive coach out there works every single time they run through individual practice. You got to trust them.
Here's a reverse. Back to Long. The ball loose, and NC State trying to collapse on it after Fernandez and Rose sandwiched Long. Oh, Syracuse man. Recovers it, and the Wolfpack came within a whisker that time of a big play.
Well, you draw it up, you get a team on its heels. You get them feeling down a little bit and trying to go with a great big home run hit. But these guys, including the freshman Fernandez, not having it. This very disciplined defense.
The ball was fumbled and recovered by Syracuse. That play is under further review.
We've seen them time and time again. It was even Arius Moore in that game against Louisville. Remember Louisville, they tried to play some trickery on him there. Right. It's a well-coached linebacking unit, and they sniff it out, and so lucky to get this back. I doubt Scott Schaefer's team will try to get cued again here this afternoon. That's a fumble.
Yeah. And Ben Lewis is the closest guy in an orange helmet to recover the loose ball here, but looks like, boy, Dravius Wright was in on that.
Well, he's everywhere. I'm a fan of number 8 in the white uniform. He's just a sophomore. We're going to be talking about him for years to come.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Second down.
Right. Great job to just muscle that one away. Ben Lewis, we talked about the hands, how important that was on the touchdown catch. And this one right here to keep the Mighty Mo on the side of the orange. Even though they've got second down and 21 to go now.
Second sack of Long today by the Wolfpack. Loss of 11. Long overthrows West. And again, State's front getting a little pressure there. Niles Clark was in the back end in the coverage for State, but Mike Rose, big 90, has been around the ball a lot today from his defensive end spot.
You get in this situation down deep in your own end, and you're likely to go a little screen or a draw just to be safe. But try to take a big chunk out of this. Make a little play here.
Here's Gulley. And he'll be tackled at the 36, 37-yard line by Hakeem Jones. But French Tyson got a good bit of that back.
Get this offensive line healthy again. This French Tyson Gulley. He's fun to watch. There's an extra little bit of juice that you don't see in every back across the college football landscape. When he gets his hands on the ball, he's determined. Just not quite enough there for him. So here comes the punting unit, but you better believe NC State is alerted to a fake punt here. This is, oh, I'm sorry, is going to try to kick field goal.
Oh. And here they go. Look at all the big fellas. Thompson, some of those guys, and Amin Moore got the ball, and a marker goes down. Kiefer tried to sneak in Ron Thompson and also Micah Robinson in almost the old stack eye look.
Correction, timeout, North Carolina State.
And then Riley Dixon, the punter, went up under center. And Adonis Amin Moore dropped to the back of the big eye. And I mean a big eye. Because Amin Moore at 234 was a lightweight behind Thompson at 257 and Robinson at 270.
30-second timeout.
It was a capital, bold-faced eye. And you know what? And it's a timeout. Dave Dorn and the whole sidelines quickly calling that timeout when they made the big shift. But you look at it, that play wasn't going anywhere. Art Norman was sitting 3 yards deep in the backfield ready to blow it up.
Scott Schaefer not happy at all. He thought he had it dead to rights and snapped before the timeout was asked for. So now Riley Dixon will likely punt this, which is what we thought he was going to do a moment ago. Well, we actually thought he was going to try a field goal.
Well, and you got to be careful here. You don't punt it out of the back of the end zone. Hurt your defense.
Trying to flip it over. And it checks up, but back to the 10-yard line. And the Orange tracked that down. Well done, Zaire Franklin, the linebacker. State trails five at Syracuse.
On the field.
ACC football is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the Atlantic Coast Conference, Toyota, Havilland, and Food Lion. Well, first Saturday in November, oh, we got a little wind here now. We got a little wind today.
You need wind. It helps to push the sail.
Is that right?
That's what Tommy Boy says. No wind in here in the carrier down there, is there?
No, no, sir. No AC either. Another story for another day. Brissett. Can't get there. He had beaten Brandon Reddish. Richie Desir was late. And Brian Underwood, the redshirt senior, on the deep post.
Well, Brian had a 65-yard touchdown catch against the Presbyterian Blue Hose. And this one was almost the biggest play of the year for NC State. He knew that it was going to be close. Turned on the jets. Nobody was going to touch him. It was just a little too strong. So here's your second down and long now. After coming up empty, trying to go for the great big one.
Look left. Pumps. Now Brissett to run with it. And wow, took a big lick at the 17. Eric Krum from Detroit. Brandon Reddish, the corner. Oh, coming right at you, Batesy.
How about the toughness of this set? No running out of bounds here. He goes and takes three big licks. Guess who? Right in the middle of it, Dyshawn Davis. Dyshawn with his 44th start here this afternoon. Most on the team. Over on the other end, the other outside linebacker. 23rd straight start for Cameron Lynch. Wow. We're going to need those guys right here on a third down and short. Big, big play.
Thornton in the running back spot. Gets the carry. And he needs the 20 for the first down. I don't think he gets it. It's Zaire Franklin. Made the stop.
Fourth down, and it was Dyshawn Davis. Talked about penetration, what it does to an offense. Well, Dyshawn Davis saw run all the way, comes firing through there to light up that gap, and he started the confusion in the backfield and dropped on a huge third down and short, and there's a big stand by this Syracuse Orange defense. That wasn't happening early in this football game. They were running at will. Everything that they were rolling out there was working for the Wolfpack.
And now the play clock runs out.
Delay a game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
I'm not sure, given where they were field of play that Dave Doran wanted to sell off 5 yards there, but maybe they wanted to see if Syracuse could hold up.
Two straight three and outs for Chuck Fuller's defense.
Bauman hammers that at Richie Desir at the 25. Desir and out of bounds at the 35. Jonathan Austin covered it for the Wolfpack. Arsenovas, greatness made here. Oh, Bates, I know you were in Gainesville, but here it's got a whole lot to it.
Doesn't it?
Started with Jim Brown, Floyd Little, Ernie Davis. But Jim Brown, even today you look at the numbers and you still go, wow. Not only great in football, three times lacrosse All-America. And yeah, the 44, it's all over the place.
25 players wore it. Rob Conrad, the fullback, went on to play for the Dolphins. Tough, tough guy. The last one to wear it. You know what I like? How much respect that 44 gets around here. They even changed the zip code from 13210 to 13244 at Syracuse University. That's some respect right there.
How about if you're on this list? Yards per carry all time. Prince Tyson is on a chart with Jim Brown. James Mungro, whose career here is way underrated on a national perspective. Boy, they've had some really good football players here in Central New York. And Prince Tyson can't get around Thomas Teal that time. Boy, big 69 had some help from Jared Fernandez, but this redshirt senior Teal is starting to show up a lot for Doran's defense.
Well, he is. He big and strong, can move. It was him and T.Y. McGill, the nice rotation there. That left defensive tackle spot. It's been up to big 69 here as of late, though, with McGill's suspension.
4.5 to go in the third. Long looking for cousin Jared West. And did he make it? It's ruled a catch at the 35 of NC State. Niles Clark battled Jared West there.
Look at the energy. Big smile as he looks over to get his play again. Hey, this is what they hit the big hitter on, dropping it right in there as the true freshman quarterback. And again with the catch, again with the hands. We've seen some outstanding catches from A.J. Long's receivers here this afternoon to get him back in this game and take the lead.
Adonis Amin Moore pushes the stack for about 5, maybe 6 on first down. Fernandez, the redshirt freshman at linebacker, the stop. Long is now 12 of 23, a buck 95, a couple scores.
It's easy to forget when Coach Scott Schaefer said puppies right there in the thick of that offensive line. They're playing with these young guys because the older guys are hurt.
Here's Phillips around the edge on the option from Long. And another first down for the Orange.
And we're talking about guys like senior John Miller. Rob Trudeau's a senior. Nick Robinson's a senior. To have to replace them with young guys, puppies he called them, inexperienced guys. It takes them some time to get into a rhythm. But they're starting to hold their own, and everything is starting to produce yardage.
Long. Intercepted. And off to the races for the Wolfpack. McKeever needs a block. Get one from Dravius Wright, and he will score. And what a play for NC State.
Just what the Wolfpack needed. Look at the long, lean defensive end. 6'6", 240-pounder. And a guy that started off West as, you guessed it, a wide receiver. You see that? What is that, a one-week-old making his way to the carrier dome?
Yep. Tell you what, the baby and the pack are back in front.
Oh, that's a little guy getting some action in here. Wow.
And I got to tell you, McKeever, who was a safety at Tabor City, North Carolina. It started as a wide receiver for NC State, now playing defensive end. Just went 82 to the house. And now the Pack going for two. Shovel pass, Days into the end zone. And it's 17-14. NC State, Joe Tooney, one of the veteran guys on that offensive line, squared up the alley for Days to score.
Syracuse defense got strong all of a sudden, forced two three and outs, so leave it up to the offense. Little zone dog blitz. That's a way to confuse a true freshman. Hey, you think you know where everybody's coming from? Why not drop out a defensive end into coverage? And Dravius Wright, if NC State can hang on and win this game, not a lot of the things in the box score are going to show up, but number eight has been the juice in all phases of this football game. And look at that for a defensive end to get rolling. How about the block at the end to punch it in and take the lead back?
And Ryan Nielsen coaches that defensive line. He and Dave Doran know that's a big play for the Wolfpack, Jen.
Well, Wes, that wasn't exactly the kind of play that these two former Syracuse Orange players would have liked to have seen. But Jerome Smith, Marquise Spruill, got to ask you guys, now with the Atlanta Falcons, by the way, back for a game, what would you be saying right now on the sideline if this had just happened to you? Start with you, Keith.
You know, just make sure people don't get down. We're still out here. We got a lot of time left in the game, and we can still do something. So just don't get down. It's a mistake. Let's come back. All right, next drive. Put some points up.
Jerome, I know you just got back from London. Is this the first chance you've had to get back here to Syracuse?
This is my first chance. Just tell the defense keep doing what they're doing. And offense, we got to step it up.
Now, what do you guys like about this team? Last year, you found a way to fight, get to a goal. Does this team have that same ability, do you think?
I think so. I watched them playing some of the bigger games, and they've done a really good job. I mean, stuff just has to click. They lost the quarterback, lost some of the linemen. It's little things. They'll get it together, though.
I've seen you guys. You, Marquise, you were sitting there on the bench for a while. You just can't stop yourself talking to the guys, right? You got to be talking to them this week.
So you have to. You know, we were just here last year, so it's like we know most of the people on the team. We know everybody, and we're still close. So you got to go there.
He will always be Captain Keys. Guys, I'll let you pull that photo up when you get the chance. Fellas, thanks so much. We appreciate it.
Jen, thanks. And thanks to Marquise Spruill and Jerome Smith. Both members of the Atlanta Falcons, Spruill on injured reserve, tore an ACL earlier in training camp, and Smith on the practice squad for Mike Smith's club.
And Q's coming right back to the air, and one thing that has worked, he's connected twice with his cousin. A.J. Long has Jared West, and that one just off the fingertips. For a guy who's had trouble dropping it in the zones, he's done well today.
And now the Wolfpack rally into the football. Jim was talking about Captain Keys a year ago. Up here on campus, there's Captain Keys. Halloween night, huh? You're the captain of the defense? That's what your getup would be in Gainesville, wouldn't it? Something like that, huh?
Captain Keys looks tough, though, without all the camo on. Hey. There have been some great linebackers that have come through here over the years. We're seeing a couple here today.
Third and 11. And Long throws it out of bounds. The Wolfpack in pursuit. That was Brandon Pittman, the weak side linebacker, who got up in the throwing lane of A.J. Long. So a three and out after McKeever's big play. And Riley Dixon will punt it away.
Dave Huxtable's defense after the big play by McKeever come out and quick three and out.
Yep.
How can Jacoby Brissett and this offense move it a little bit? Something they've struggled with here lately.
End over end kick by Dixon, not his best of the day. It'll bounce in front of Hines. And he's going to let it bounce, and Syracuse will touch it up, and NC State will play off its 33-yard line. Now with a three-point lead. Next Saturday, we'll get you one of these two in our package. We'll either see Paul Johnson and Georgia Tech and Carter Finley against the Wolfpack, or we'll be right back here at the Carrier Dome for Duke, who won today in double overtime at Pittsburgh against the Orange. One of those two games for you next week on ACC College Football Saturday. Anthony Boone, Jamison Crowder, and Boone, a big day today for the Blue Devils, who put up 51 in a double overtime victory against the Panthers. And Shad Thornton from Matt Days, 21 through the line for about three or four. NC State only 14 yards of offense so far here in the half. Syracuse 108, but McKeever's pick six is the story, James. And Brissett to throw, an offline for Jonathan Austin. So now third down very quickly here for NC State.
Well, they try to go back to the tempo. When they were rolling early in this football game, and Syracuse wasn't able to get off the field and stop this North Carolina State Wolfpack offense, this is the tempo that they brought. Now they'll huddle up, a big third down and seven. You see the yellow line right at about the 43, a line to make. Walked up and showing blitz everybody.
Here's Brissett underneath Cherry and got bottled up quick. Eskridge led the tacklers for Syracuse. Zaire Franklin also there. And so NC State has to punt it back.
Well, the pressure comes as they're trying to set up this little wide receiver screen. But again, those vice angles that we've talked about. Here's Franklin was the other side of that vice angle, and it was Darrell Eskridge who came up with the big stick. So two defenses and it really pinned their ears back and started to play some hard-nosed football here in the second half.
Bauman punts it away to Desir at the 11. And the Wolfpack tried to hem him up, and out to the 25 goes Richie Desir before Jalen Samuels, the fullback, makes the stop after a 52-yard punt from Will Bauman. And here comes A.J. Long in the orange back out, James. Long came into this game hitting just 58% of his passes. Under 5 yards an attempt. His yards per attempt number today is up near 8. And he's had a pretty crisp day throwing the football. But he hadn't had to throw it a lot, right?
Well, even on the couple misses, that last miss was truly centimeters just off of his cousin's fingertips. A very confident young man, and the confidence is gained when he gets big gainers on first down. When the running game can go and help him out, Wes, gosh, it opens up so many things and lets him just breathe a little bit, and they've started to have success on the ground.
This is Adonis Amin Moore, and we've seen three of the four running backs, and George Morris, the second, has been on the field for a snap but has not carried the ball as of yet.
Amin Moore must just like cold weather. He comes from Denver all the way up here to Syracuse, traveled a long way. Off the ground in the backfield, back to tailback now. He looked good there.
And they'll check it down. Here's Amin Moore. Man, big fella, 235 plus. He hit Rodman Noel straight up. And then finally worked out of bounds after about a 4-yard gain. James, I'm telling you now, this is a big man. You go hunting wood, you better take a lot with you, huh?
Well, and he showed you the play before. He turned on the jets and got the corner on Noel. That time he ran him right over. Noel weighs 225, Wes.
Well, we're setting ourselves up for an exciting final period of play for the Carrier Dome. State with a 3-point lead. You look at the facts and filaments of this ball game, James. In the third quarter, NC State took the lead despite 17 yards of offense. Syracuse had 124 yards of offense in the third quarter. Here we go. Big 15 minutes for both schools, isn't it?
Absolutely. Wolfpack with a great big play, interception return for the touchdown.
Off the hands of the tight end Moore. Kendall Moore couldn't hang on. There's a breakdown.
Well, and it was only 9 points on the board for NC State with that 204 yards of total offense in the first half.
Big third down play for Long. In trouble. Sacked. Marker down. Brandon Pittman got to A.J. Long. Clock will stop on the official whistle.
They've heated it up time and time again on this true freshman.
Illegal formation. Offense. 5 men in the backfield. That penalty's declined. Fourth down.
helping Riley Dixon.
And this defense, and the injuries, you go back to, it's not just a suspension of McGill, but early in the season, when they lost all those linebackers, it's not the deepest of units. When they're fresh, they really have good jump on this pass rush, and it showed again there.
The ball is hammered at Hines by Riley Dixon, a fair catch call for by NC State. So, early here in the final period of play at the Carrier Dome. Tell you what, we had a magic pumpkin there. Carved up yesterday, it's held up here today. ACC football is brought to you by CPI Security and by your local Ford dealer. And there's a look at the Hendricks Chapel on campus here at Syracuse with James Bates, Jen Hilbreth, West Durham. We welcome you back indoors for NC State and the Orange. And great second and third effort from Matt Days of the Wolfpack to the 20-yard line. Setting up second down, and Dave Doran's team. Here's the offense. Three and outs and three punts.
Did we just change that graphic from orange to red? Because the first half, that's the way it looked for Syracuse. How about Days, the sophomore back there? Told you about that 1-2-3 punch, refusing to go down. It's going to take that kind of fight from both these teams to pull out a win here today.
Brissett shoots it out to Hines. And very close to the first down on second down is Bo Hines. Richie DeSeer in coverage for Syracuse. Boy, you got a lot to be really excited about the rookie campaign that Hines has had, James.
Came in early, so he had a chance to build some chemistry with another new guy, Jacoby Brissett. You know, he's a junior, but a transfer from Florida. And they muscle up now here and get a fresh set of downs.
Sweep it. Coming near side. And working back is Samuels. Jalen Samuels still on his feet. Finally run out of bounds at the 48 of the Orange. Two big plays today. One on the fake punt. And a third and short sweep by the 240-pound freshman from Charlotte, Jalen Samuels.
Just enough. It looked like the outside to force everybody back in. But Samuels puts his foot in the ground. And looked like he was going to be stuffed for a no gainer. Did I say three guys in the backfield? Throw in Samuels as well. Oh, what a play call there. Everybody's bunched inside thinking they're going to just punch it, trying to get a couple inches. Instead, they go outside. First down and a whole lot more on into Syracuse territory.
28-yard run, and the Orange bang away at Days on first down. That's a loss of two. Boy, Syracuse got Micah Robinson and Robert Welsh, the two defensive ends, in the mix. And Marcus Coleman, big 55, has come in to play in that front now for the Orange.
Well, and Robinson may not be the most athletic up front, but 93 just showed you he's probably the toughest there on that play. Just fighting to get those pads lower than the offensive line. And dropping the back for a big loss.
Cherry in motion. Second down, Brissett. Buys time. And to the far side, Valdez-Scantlin. Boy, Jacoby Brissett has gotten away from harm a couple of times here today and been able to throw completed passes for productive yardage.
I don't know how he got out of the hands. Vigil right there, ran right through his blocker. And here they get him in open space. Brissett, calm and cool enough with all the pressure in his face to get it out there. Forcing another third down and short instead of getting sacked for a big drop for a loss.
Greenwich has been quiet here in the second half. Here's Thornton. Marker down. Thornton has a first down out of bounds at the 27. The flag is thrown behind the play. Dyshawn Davis knocked him out of bounds. Here's Jeff Heaser.
Illegal shift. Offense. Two men in motion. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So that'll take away the conversion for Dave Doran's Wolfpack.
What a killer, too. Gosh, everything seems to be working, and it's right now. They're attacking the perimeter, and they're just becoming better athletes. The Wolfpack on the outside. But where that spreads you thin is you start committing guys on the outside to stop the bleeding, and they can punch it right up the gut. Here you've got 8 yards to go now to stay on the field.
Four receivers in the set, including the tight end. Brissett.
They got to call a hold.
They do. And Jacoby Brissett will get out of bounds. 4 yards shy of the first down. Ron Thompson was held by Tyson Chandler.
They have not wanted to call any holding calls all day long.
Scott Schaefer is trying to think this over because of the math. They're going to push state back.
Holding offense number 74. And 10-yard penalty. Third down.
Let me ask you, James, if he declines it, it's fourth and four. Watch takes it. It's third and long.
Watch it. Well, and it's, look at him. I mean, there have been many times. And earlier in the game, it was a Thomas Teal that got held in a big way. So it's finally the yellow flags come out. And it, third down and forever now because of it.
Creasy into the game with Brissett in the backfield. Syracuse brings four. And here's Greenwich trying to get some of this back. And let's see, they measure him out of bounds at the 43, so it'll be fourth and five. And Bauman comes on to punt. Cam Lynch at the tight end, David Greenwich.
Well, Dave Doran asking his senior punter, best average in the ACC, probably the best touch I've seen all year long, at pinning him down there deep. Do it one more time for the big man.
He flips it over toward DeSeer. It will fair catch at the six. So there's where the Orange will play from. Under 10 to go. NC State with a three-point lead.
On the field.
And a tick under 10 minutes to play at the Carrier Dome. And NC State 17, Syracuse 14, and A.J. Long in the Orange spreading things out on first and 10 off their six. Out in the flat, here's Lewis. And Bravius Wright shoves him out of bounds, shy of the 12. Jen and A.J. Long in the Orange trying to get back here.
Yeah, it was interesting talking to A.J. this week. He said he didn't feel like he was mentally prepared enough for that Clemson game. Said things were a blur. So he told me he spent more time in the film room this week than he has all season long. Got some momentum the last drive. Let's see what he can do here.
Well, here's Prince Tyson Gully. NC State, McKeever, who had the pick six of 82 yards to give State the lead, makes the play there.
Well, and Jen, you know, A.J. Long, no matter how prepared you are, you get a little bit fuzzy when you get hammered from the very first snap.
Yeah, Clemson, Grady Jarrett.
That defense of Clemson, they were in his face all day long, just gobbled him up and made him look like a true freshman.
And they're going to run a little boot here. And caught Ishmael. Steve Ishmael at the 30.
Well, pretty cool there, Wes. Not fuzzy at all. The true freshman. They turn his back. Turns his back to the defense to roll him. Boom. Turns around and hits it right on the money to Ishmael, who had the big touchdown catch earlier. This one probably just as big to convert on a third down and two and get something moving for the Orange finals.
Dumps it out in the flat. Prince Tyson shoved out of bounds by Rodland Noel. You know, the interesting, I asked A.J. yesterday, what was the biggest crowd Friendship Christian played in front of in Lebanon, Tennessee? Oh, 3,500, maybe 4,000. You had 81-5 staring down at you last Saturday night at Frank Howard Field. That'll make things a little fuzzy, too, won't it?
Oh, my goodness, Death Valley.
The partisans of Tiger Town can blur the vision.
Don't you question the rowdiness of those Tennessee high school games, though, Wes.
And trapped in the backfield. B.J. Hill grabs Adonis Amin Moore And the big freshman from Oakboro, North Carolina, has another tackle behind the line.
Coming off this bye week, these guys, well, someone's got to block them, but it's been very impressed with across the board. Guys like Art Norman, Thomas Tip, E.J. Hill, the first step. They've been quick, they've used their hands, and they put pressure time and time again in this backfield.
Third and long again. And Long looking to throw. Scrambles. Amin Moore the catch. And he'll be short of the first down by about 3 yards. Brandon Pittman, Jack Tocho. And NC State sees Dixon come on the punt for Syracuse.
Good job. Let him have it. You can have that all day long when it's third down and really long like that. Play those chains. Know where they're trying to go and come up and make a nice, clean, open field tackle. Force the punt.
And Bo Hines. The fair catch at the 30. So, under 7 to go now. Fourth quarter. The Orange trail the Wolfpack 17-14. Just under 7 to go. Wolfpack will play off its 30-yard line when we rejoin you from the Carrier Dome. And our Scott Schaefer getting ready to go. Dave Dorn. These two teams collectively lost 9 of their last 10, but they're not out of postseason hope.
They have not folded up the tent. They continue to fight and play hard. And remember, folks, this is a defense from Syracuse that has just given up 10 points. The 7 points was an interception return.
Well, the Orange defense has been really good. There are Honda Generators power play. And just look at the movement. The linebackers have been about what we expected, maybe even better, James. Chuck Bullis' group is strong. Second and 8.
Against the run. Blitzing like we see right here.
Brissett looking for room. Gonna put it up into the bench area, out of the tackle box. Zaire Franklin had him wrapped up. Kirkland is flying over there as well. That ball, I'll tell you what, come to the ball game, get you a nice seat, and you get you a football.
This is what I like, too. Zaire Franklin is a backup. He's a freshman. And the freshman out of Philly, they trust him in these huge moments of this football game. Putting trust in some of these guys to give the starters a breather. Let them stay fresh as we go down the stretch here. And the youngsters are making plays, too.
Blitz coming from the Orange. Brissett in trouble, sacked. Ron Thompson, Micah Robinson.
Looked like they wanted to set up a screen here on the near side. Watch Brissett with the pump, and it's the pump is all the time that these guys need. It's exactly what they were trying to do. Changed his mind, and there wasn't going to be anything there, because that's what you want, is you want those guys to heat it up. Helps those screens to develop, those offensive linemen to get down the field.
It toward DeSeer at the 31. Richie DeSeer looking for room. Tried to cut back. Jonathan Austin wrestles him down, and now we got a flag because back up field, Jalen Samuels got tied up with linebacker Paris Bennett. 44-yard punt. Here's Jeff Heaser.
Two fouls on the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the kicking team. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the receiving team. Those penalties offset. Result to play, first down.
So Syracuse will maintain possession. And we'll step aside. 5:23 to go. NC State, 3-point edge.
We're going to be a hard-nosed team that plays the game with physicality. We're going to take kids that nobody knew about, and by the time they graduate, you'll know their names are Chandler Jones or Arthur Jones or Daryl Johnston or Dwight Freeney. Rob Moore, guys that weren't highly coveted in the recruiting magazines that ended up being some of the best players in the NFL that came through Syracuse. And let's stay true to who we are and don't apologize for it.
You like that, don't you?
I love that. I'll add a few to it. Morlon Greenwood was a great linebacker. Nate Hemsley, guy I played with. Rob Burnett played for my dad for a lot of years in Cleveland. Rob Burnett is one of the best defensive linemen you'll ever see. Great guys that came out here. A lot of great defenders, too.
Long on first down, off the 38. And off the hands of his tight end, Paris, and a marker thrown. And there's a marker at the 35. We'll sort this out. I think the receiver, Paris, went out of bounds and came back in and touched the ball before it was touched by somebody else. And therefore, that'll be a penalty against the Orange.
If he was forced out, he can reestablish himself.
And so Jeff Heiser and his crew want to make sure they've got this tidied up.
There are two fouls on the play. The offensive player number 89 went out of bounds and was first to touch the ball. That penalty is declined. Holding offense number 57. 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
Amari Palmer guilty of the hold. James, the thing that Scott Schaefer may benefit from just a touch in his foundation is that he was here with Doug Marrone, who's now the head coach of the Bills. And, of course, Schaefer was here 09 through 12 as the defensive coordinator.
And, you know, it's funny, right before we went to break, that's the physicality. That's the style he wants. You don't want a 15-yard penalty. So, fortunately for both coaches, it offset.
Yeah.
But you get guys so fiery hot and wanting to play physical football, you get some fisticuffs from time to time. But you can't have bad penalties that take you backwards.
Long scrambling, sacked. Back at the 26, and a marker will be thrown in on the top there because NC State got a little overzealous making the play. Justin Jones, the defensive tackle.
Personal foul, defense, number 93. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Again, there you see the motor double-teamed. And you got to pull up. In real time, at first it looked like it was a shame, but he actually dives when the quarterback is down. And that's a tough penalty. Yep. You're hustling so hard, you want a payoff, but your buddy's just made the play. Pull up. First down and a freebie for an offense that was reeling a little bit.
Wolfpack playing out of character in that category today for sure. One of the best in the country with 9 today is State. And here's Long, forced out again. And he'll try and scramble up the field and gets to about the 42, maybe the 43. For a guy making his third start, A.J. Long plays with a little bit of poise, doesn't he, Batesy?
Oh, not just a little bit. It's, you know, a true freshman.
Yeah.
This is, you know, looked like a junior if you didn't know any better. And it was from the very get-go. Comes in against the number two team in the nation, Florida State Seminoles, and plays really well.
Second down, Long going to throw. Ishmael, midfield, first down for the Orange, and brought down at the 45. Tocho there on the tackle.
Another late flag.
And here's a flag again at midfield.
They've got to clean it up, Wes. That's a perfect example, Wes. You saw Long. He takes a hit. He stands in there strong, knowing he's going to get popped, and he has time and time again. He's just dealt with the pressure, been so cool, and gets another one off.
Yep.
This flag is going to be big because I don't think it's going to be offsetting here.
Personal foul. Offense number 70. Illegal low block. 15 yards from the spot of the foul. Still second down.
So that post-scrimmage will take it back to the 35-yard line. Boy, Schaefer in the Orange. We'll have to try and overcome this one. You know, the interesting thing, and I mentioned this to you, James, and Jen and I were touching on it yesterday as well. A.J. Long looks like one of these guys. His mom dropped him off to play here today. I mean, he's young. You know, his last old coach used to say his last big crowd he saw was his prom. And he just plays with so much confidence, this young fellow.
Got such a natural knack to play this quarterback position. Look at him step up here.
Fumble. And just their third fumble of the year.
And it's a different guy. The guys that they have rolled in there up front for NC State, they've done such a good job of keeping them fresh. And the pressure has come time and time again. A.J. Long has stood in there and taken his shots. Here he doesn't protect the ball. Boom, knocked out by Rodman Noel. Yep. Noel gets his hand, clips it a little bit on the elbow. Or no, it's just, shoot, I don't even know that the arm or the ball was hit. And Kenton Gibbs is going to come up with it.
Yep.
And, oh, what a giant stop for Dave Huxtable's defense. Aided a little bit by some penalties here on this drive.
Well, Kenton Gibbs, big redshirt freshman who tore an Achilles last year in preseason, therefore was sidelined all year, comes up with a fumble recovery. Rodman Noel, the injured Wolfpack player, has played another big ball game today for NC State. And Dave Thorne now, with under 4 minutes to go, his team is plus two today in the takeaway.
Ray Nielsen's guys up front, I mentioned it earlier, defensive line coach. You know, all the coaches got their family picture in the media guide for NC State. Wives and daughters, his family, all of his defensive line. And boy, is his family celebrating in the backfield today.
You see just the third fumble of the year for the Orange. First down, Days hops through a tackler and then inside the 30 to the 28. So Matt Days, and now NC State, under 4 minutes, trying to burn a little clock here, James.
Wow, watch him wash him down. A great job up front. Tony Adams. Big guard from Charlotte. Started that big wash and creating that big hole. Let this clock just tick on down. Second down and two coming up now.
Let's go, Bowden.
Single back is Days. You see Greenwich and also Cole, the two tight end, or Purvis, but the fullback is in there. And here's Days. And that'll be a first down for the Wolfpack. And the clock will move inside of 3 minutes once they move these chains. Dyshawn Davis, Cam Lynch on the stop. Dave Doran's team trying to get the elusive first win in the ACC.
Not just this year. You imagine the pressure. You'd never, as a coach, you wouldn't expect him to admit to it. But that pressure, trying to go get that first one, and it's huge. But there's a lot of football to be played, and they need more than three right here. And they need to find a way to get in the paint.
Here's Days. Cutting back. Took a big lick. Kept his feet. And they'll mark his progress toward the 21. So it'll be about second down and six when play resumes. Darius Kelly was the guy that really popped him. And Syracuse uses the first of the three timeouts with 2:27 to play. Well, time for the Z-Max performance play of the game. And I think I know where we're going here, James.
Well, of course. The former wide receiver knowing exactly what to do. Little zone dog blitz. They drop the defensive end into coverage. It fools the true freshman quarterback, A.J. Long, and Farrell McKeever.
Take care of your guy, Dravius, right here at the block, because I know you're a big fan of Wright, number 8.
I am right there with the dreads, hustling down, doing all he can to give a knock to A.J. Long.
And Farrell, that's the difference.
I know as much as you like the D.N. scoring, you like 8 hustling down the field to pave the way on the last 5 or 6 yards, huh?
I just get so excited when these guys do the little things that don't show up.
Right.
Like just fighting to keep an outside shoulder. The little things that you just don't get a lot of credit for, like a lot of these offensive linemen. And that's one of them, partner, right there.
Here's a sweep with Cherry. And Braylon Cherry will be hemmed in at the 18, and it'll be third and 4 or so. And Syracuse stops the clock with 2:21 with their second timeout.
really like the play call because you've punched them inside, had a lot of success. You know they're geared up to stop that inside run, but you don't want to take a chance of going an incomplete pass. You want that clock to continue to run. So to get to the outside, you run that jet sweep.
Yep.
But on the other side, Syracuse, outstanding to pop out there and defend it and shut it down in the quick timeout to stop the clock.
Yeah. Well, Syracuse is down to two timeouts. Now, Jen, all I can think is Ryan Nielsen started handing out the belt last week. And I got to believe Farrell McKeever's in play for the belt if the Wolfpack win here today.
Yeah, you think so, Wes. Mike Rose, number 90, junior defensive end, is going to have to take it down off of his wall. That's where it is right now. We saw Art Norman sporting the belt last year. And, yeah, this is something Ryan Nielsen gives to his defensive lineman for getting off the ball quickly. I think he might give it for a big INT, though, too.
Here's the third down play, and Thornton has the first down and the touchdown. 18-yard throw, Jacoby Brissett to Shadrack Thornton.
First half, Syracuse would let them get down here, and then they'd stiffen. Watch the blocks. First, it's Valdez-Scantling on the left side of your screen. And on the other side, it was Braylon Cherry, who was just out of frame, to open up that hole. Nice swing, and again, a nice play call to make it a two-score difference.
Ten-point lead for the Pack. Oh, nice move in space, huh?
Absolutely. Eskridge, who's usually a sure tackler coming from a safety spot, just broken down. Oh, and what a big afternoon here for NC State. And still, a couple minutes left to play. And again, Dave Doran trying to get win number one as a head coach at NC State in the ACC and trying to turn the tide on a four-game losing streak after starting this year 4-0.
Yep.
And one win away, if they can hang on, from bowl eligibility.
Well, and you start looking at the Wolfpack, a 10-point lead now with 2:14 to go. State would snap the four-game skid. They'd be 5-4. Not only their first win in the league, two of their last three games would be at home. Georgia Tech next Saturday at 12:30, Wake Forest in Raleigh, and then to Chapel Hill for the State Carolina game at Keenan Stadium. And if you're NC State, we start at the top of the broadcast today talking about young teams, postseason ambition. Destination is almost irrelevant. It's what systematically happens when you go to a bowl. You practice. You have an opportunity to get redshirt guys extra practice time. Guys who maybe have not gotten as many snaps in game, James.
And Dave Doran has one of the youngest football teams in the nation.
Yep.
And so guys who may not even go and start in that bowl game, that month, an extra month of practice, what that can do for a program, that's why the rich keep getting richer. And some of these teams just scrapping to try to get up there. And here is the rest of the schedule. We're back home in Raleigh, as you mentioned, against Georgia Tech, and then the Deacs come to town, and then finish it up at North Carolina, who became the hottest team in the ACC until this week, and Miami cooled the heels off quite a bit.
Miami a winner today, Boston College a winner, Duke in double overtime. Here's A.J. Long looking to throw, and incomplete. Looking far side for Jared West.
And I'll say this, Wes, about this Dave Doran coach team. It's a team that impresses me with the way they continue to fight all four quarters. There's a very tough guy over there leading the show, just like Scott Schaefer. But it's, you know, we had him at Louisville, and they left nine guys back home. The BB gun incident, guys getting in trouble. Looked to be done, came out fighting in the second half. Look at this catch.
Wow, Ben Lewis up the ladder in front of Josh Jones at the 44-yard line. And Syracuse with 2 minutes to go.
When you get guys in man-to-man coverage, A.J. Long has a certain knack for just putting it up there where only his guys can go get it. There's another perfect example.
And that time, this man toward the 49, Tocho makes the play.
Trying to find a way to stop this clock.
Syracuse hurrying up to the line. Remember, the Orange have just one timeout left. Down 10 now.
Gotta go, though. Gotta go.
Far side and West the catch. And he gets out of bounds at the State 42 ahead of Niles Clark, who had him around the ankle. So with 89 seconds left. And for A.J. Long, a third start. He's thrown a couple touchdown passes, but an interception and a fumble here in the second half that produced 14 points for NC State.
Quick with this snap. Here comes all the pressure.
Yep, he'll take the deep shot. And broken up. Downfield for Funderburk. I believe. No, Sean Avant, I'm sorry. 83, the intended receiver for the Orange here.
And it's Jones. And there it is. And that's what we've talked about. We haven't always seen that today, both sides. It's been good position. But the technique to finish it hasn't been there. There it was for Jones.
Long middle of the field, West the catch. Josh Jones there, but A.J. Long's 39th attempt of the day down the seam to Jared West.
Well, it's getting closer to Thanksgiving when cousins come over, eat a lot of food, and go play ball out front. It's like Thanksgiving weekend here today in the Carrier Dome. Jared West and A.J. Long, the cousins, just hooking up with big play after big play.
Inside route, incomplete, and a marker thrown. Intended for Cornelius, or Avant, I'm sorry, 83 Avant.
Holding, offense number 78, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Scott Schaefer knows that'll back his club up.
You see the difference. That's the one thing. When this Wolfpack front has had some rest, when they've got a chance to get fresh, there's been an extra just pep in their step. When they get on their heels, when they get winded a little bit, it's the Syracuse offensive line that's won the battles.
And Art Norman will get the sack of A.J. Long, and the clock moves under a minute to play. The senior from Stone Mountain, Georgia. And Scott Schaefer will burn the final timeout here. A.J. Long, unless he reaches into his back pocket for a miracle, is going to take a loss here, but he's thrown for over 300 yards. And he's made some big-time throws.
Well, this one to Lewis, who missed a couple games with an injury. Scott Schaefer making sure. That was right before half. First 7 points, and there's the second seven. And this is what I like about him, too, the juice that he brings to the sidelines, but also the zone dog blitz by NC State. He throws a touchdown to the wrong color jersey this time. And forever, that was the difference. And now trying to charge down the field and a couple mistakes here late when they've tried to giddy up and making them pay on that one. Through the air, Brissett, the Shadrack Thornton.
You know, it's interesting. Then you see the throw down the seam to West. That put him over 300 yards passing for the freshman Long. James, in talking to these coaches on both staffs, ironically both in their second year, they've come to these spots in their careers at various times, but they all want to play fast. They all coach hard. These teams are well drilled, and it's not easy. It's not easy to win. But man, they give you great effort on both sides, don't they? That's why I think this has been a fairly entertaining and competitive ball game from the standpoint, not pretty at times, but at the same time, you couldn't ask for a harder hitting physical ball game.
No, absolutely. They've gotten everything, not always technique perfection, not always pretty like you said, but they've gotten an effort out of their guys. As good an effort from both teams as we've seen all year, that's for sure.
Third down, whoa, look out.
Yeah, she couldn't have it because now you don't even have a chance. You're so far back with the field goal range, where a field goal you're going to need anyway. They got to get quickly back over the football to kick an extra long field goal now.
Cole Murphy's longest is 50 at Clemson last week. This is 50. And now with 23 seconds left, Murphy hammers that one.
NC State, second charge timeout.
And Dave Doran will hold up that process. Art Norman has had a couple of big sacks here in this possession. Ooh. Wow.
Hello, so, Mr. Freshman.
Yeah. That'll get you the cold tub, won't it?
It will. Even a young, resilient freshman, you know,
young
true
kid.
Freshman. You'll be feeling it a little bit. He's just now shaking off the cobwebs from that Clemson game last weekend, the 16-6 loss.
Well, the Orange going to turn around, and here comes Duke, the winner in double overtime today, putting 51 on the board at Heinz Field. Boy, Paul Chris' team will host Syracuse on the 22nd, and then what has kind of become the Atlantic Division Northeast season finale, the game with the Orange and the Eagles of Boston College. And what about Adazio's team today?
And here we go. You hit this field goal, and all you need is that onside kick. You had to kick a field goal anyway to give yourself a chance.
And the kick is away. And it's good. 50-yarder by Murphy with 17 seconds left.
Freshman, cool as can be.
Well, and he's hit a pair of 50s. Last week at Frank Howard Field and today at home at the Carrier Dome. And Syracuse now will get the onside unit ready. And Dave Doran will go get the hands team. And everybody's got one.
We've seen outstanding special teams play. The guys with their feet, we just saw Cole Murphy, Riley Dixon's had a big day. Will Bauman has been tremendous. Nicholas Sadie, 9 points in the first half, all nine for NC State. Now can we get some special teams play one more time to make this last 17 seconds a little extra interesting?
Yep. 10 plays, 43 yards, just under 2 minutes, but the game hinges right here. North Carolina State, Dave Doran's team, will take their third and final timeout here. Tell you what, James, lots of big ball games today, including one where we had a very, very interesting coin toss today. Look at this. That's Coach Pat Dye, who was honored as the Georgia legend for the Hall of Fame yesterday. And there's Georgia. Huh?
I think she looks a little bit better than I would have if I would have been there.
Tell you what, she's sporting the 44. Huh?
She looks good in it, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Oh,
that's
man.
It. Was that the Fiesta Bowl jersey?
Yeah.
Is that the one Tommy Frazier wore?
Yeah, we washed all the blood all the grass stains off of that so Georgia would wear it.
Well, how about Georgia for the coin toss?
Oh,
and the game's going pretty well for her right now.
It is.
Well, right now it's going well.
Big day for my Gators, 31-7.
What?
Here we go.
Oh, my. That's awesome. Here's the onside.
They'll bring it back here.
Yep, it'll come back. Watch this.
We saw
it caught it right on the bounce.
Two last
the ball
weekend.
Was recovered. 10 yards behind the line of scrimmage. First down, Syracuse. That play is under further review.
Two last weekend where the defense returned it. The offense can't advance it. What they'll review now is if it went 10 yards. It absolutely looked like it on the first look there. Gosh, how'd you like to be Dave Doran? You think you've got one finally? And it's going to go down to the very last second. So it's got to go 10. It's got to go there to the 35-yard line.
Wow.
On the field, it was ruled that it did. This will be a better angle.
Yep. This might be the best look.
Hopefully, because those other two don't help us. Oh, good. Well.
Oh, I don't know. Might have to see it. They did a good job. Our
I'd like to see
up
that
top
one
camera
more time.
Right,
yeah,
here.
Here we go. Here we go. So here we go.
That's 10 yards. I mean, does he got it?
Take right here, right
just
here.
Just gotta
right
touch here. It.
He touches it.
I think this one's gonna be overturned, James.
You think so?
Yeah.
I don't know. How can you?
You can't,
if it's
called, on the field, yeah, it's on the field. You're right.
On the field, it is called Syracuse football. What happens there is it gets so grainy as you try to magnify that image. You can't tell if that's a hand or a ball. The way the ball is fluttering anyway, you can't even tell the spin change. And it's so close. I just don't see how you can say absolutely not. And
right.
So therefore, you would say it stands rather than confirm. Either way, Syracuse better be calling up, drawing up a play, and NC State better be huddled up, ready to play some defense here for the final 14 seconds.
Well, remember now, Syracuse is also out of timeouts. Well, he gets it off the carom, but it's where he touches the ball. Not where he controls it, where he makes contact with it.
Now, coaching point on that hands team, you're on the hands team not only because you have good hands, but because you're pretty tough. You got to step up and be aggressive as a defender.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. First down is Syracuse.
So off the 46 now. 13 seconds on the clock. And both schools out of timeouts. 24-17 NC State. Be awfully difficult for Syracuse to have a play where the ball is caught in the middle of the field. A.J. Long with 307 yards of passing. The 1 second coming off the clock is what has Scott Schaefer upset. Long, incomplete, looking for Lewis. Niles Clark in coverage.
Well, and Niles Clark, here's what you got to be careful of. Don't be too aggressive. Here's a look at Schaefer over there upset on the sidelines. Just keep him in front now, but don't give him a freebie by being too aggressive and too early with a pass interference penalty and letting him move it. So 10 seconds now remaining.
Three receivers here to the bottom of your screen, and here is the throw to the end zone. Custis out there, and it's intercepted. North Carolina State comes down with the interception with 1 second left. Josh Jones comes away with the pick. Second interception of the day for A.J. Long. And NC State is going to get their ACC win for Dave Doran. And a touch of the knee from Jacoby Brissett, and the Wolfpack is going to go to 5-4. Syracuse will lose for the sixth time in their last seven games. And they'll welcome Coastal Division leading Duke here next Saturday at 12:30. NC State will go to Raleigh and bring Georgia Tech to town. But here today at the Carrier Dome, two big defensive plays by the Wolfpack produced 14 points. And then Thornton added a touchdown late and proved to be the real game winner.
It was a fun football game to come up here to Syracuse and witness, be a part of. And it's just the hustle, the fight that both of these teams brought. Really appreciate the opportunity to watch them both just duke it out and play their guts out here today.
Yep.
You hate to see a loser in all this, because two teams that really, really made some big plays and gave it their all.
But it's also good to see a coach and a team that's fought so hard for that first ACC win. How's that for a smile? You don't get that very often, do you?
Well, Jen is standing by with Dave Doran.
It's fitting, isn't it, that it took a big defensive play there to finally get you this first ACC win. Coach, I know it's a big win for your team. Do you take a little personal moment of satisfaction, though, here, too?
It's all about these kids right here. I mean, it's funny because what night was it? Wednesday night, I called Farrell about 10 o'clock. I said, Farrell, I got a role for you this week. What do you think? He said, I'm at the library studying. I said, well, I think it'll help us win. Are you in? He said, Coach, I'm all in. And he made the play. So it's just proud of him. I'm proud of these players. And we've been through a lot. It was a great step. First ACC win. One away from a bowl now, and I'm proud of him.
Coach, hang here for a minute. Farrell, I've got to ask you about that big play. Former receiver, did you have to put some of those skills to use?
I came across, I saw the ball going up, so I just jumped and used my hands. And then once I got outside, I was like, oh, Lord. And I just ran for the touchdown.
How big a breakthrough can this be for your team? You guys got off to the great start, then you lost four in a row. Now you feel like you start these last four on a good note.
Oh, yes, it could be a good break. Where we was 0-1, we was winless in the conference, so this is a big conference game for us. Like, we just prepared and practiced all week, and we just came out here and got the job done.
All right, well, when Coach gives you the next call and you're studying, be sure you take it, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Congrats, Wes.
All right, Jen. Congratulations, Farrell McKeever. Congratulations, Dave Doran at NC State. Coaches in football sometimes talk about selling out. Both these clubs did here today. State a winner, 24-17. Well, you know the trip's worth it when your team wins. And here in Central New York, NC State beats Syracuse 24-17. And here's the final attempt of A.J. Long's 300-yard passing afternoon. And Josh Jones comes down with the interception. Long threw two picks, fumbled the ball. And the Wolfpack clinches the victory. 24-17, a big win for Dave Doran. They go home to host Georgia Tech next Saturday, 12:30. We might be there. We might be here for Duke's visit to the Carrier Dome, James.
Well, and NC State back in Raleigh. Boy, will they celebrate a little bit. Only 103 yards offensively in the second half, but it was the big defensive play, the interception return by McKeever, a freshman who was studying, as Coach told Jen when he found out, hey, we got a little trickery for him defensively. It worked.
82-yard pick six gave State momentum. We're set to Thornton, finished it, and State a winner. See you next Saturday with another edition of ACC College Football Saturday. For Jen Hildreth, James Bates, Dave Berger, our producer, Gary Klim, our director, and our fantastic